What is up, Donk Nation? Welcome to the first episode of Donktober, Kinda Funny's Donkey Kong 64 playthrough with the biggest DK64 fans around. I am Barrett Courtney, and I am joined by the one and only Blessing, Adeoye Jr. Blessing, how are you doing today?
Barrett Courtney, I'm doing wonderful. I had to bust out, of course, the rare jacket. I got a rep. Hold on, let me stand up and show the people the back of this
show
jacket because it's important.
Bless. Show the people. And also, just to point out, Blessing is the one playing through the game, through all of Donktober. He's got the Rareware hoodie going on right now. I've got my Nintendo 64 shirt on right now. We are ready for Donktober. And of course, in case you're wondering, for the love of God, why are we playing through Donkey Kong 64 on Kinda Funny Games in the year of our Lord 2020? If you remember, back in January when we were fundraising over on Patreon.com/KindaFunny and Patreon.com/KindaFunnyGames, one of our stretch goals was that Blessing and myself would stream through Donkey Kong 64. We didn't really know what it would look like back then. It was just kind of a blanket general, hey, these two kids who love this game for some reason are going to play through it in some way, shape, or form. Fast forward a couple months later, on a Games Daily post show, Blessing admitted to me that he has never actually rolled credits on the game.
Yes.
And it was from there that I started to put together the pieces of what Donktober needed
Let me add some clarification, because I feel like I have to defend myself on this every time it's brought up, because I don't want people to get it twisted. I played through the entirety of DK64.
It's literally like the last hour that you have not played before.
Yes, like it's basically the final boss fight that I've not done, because to unlock that final boss fight, you basically have to beat the Donkey Kong arcade game, and then you also have to beat Jetman. As a kid, or Jetpack. And as a kid, I just didn't have that brain power to beat both of those games. And so, like,
totally
legit,
fair.
Like, that's
totally
like the key to open up the final boss. And so I played through the whole game. I've not rolled credits, and that's gonna be the goal here today.
Exactly.
This month.
Yeah, that's what we're building up to this month, is a Blessing rolling credits on Donkey Kong 64 for the very first time. He needs to. Both of us have built up so much of our brands on loving this game so much that, you know, like, we just gotta get our boy to the very end of this game. So, quick shout out, Blessing, before we get into it, I just want to shout out a Kinda Funny best friend, Mike Clancy, at @M_Clancy, that's Clancy with an E,
shout out,
on Twitter, who made the Donktober logo, background, animation, etc. He made it for fun, I believe, originally, to get hyped for Donktober, to get into the Donk Nation mindset, and it was just too good that I couldn't not reach out to him to use it, just because it was fucking amazing. So shout out to Mike Clancy. He was super helpful to work with, gave us the background, the logo, the animation, everything, and it really helped us bring Donktober together visually. So shout out so much.
By the way, there is a cursor on stream. I don't know if you see this.
Yeah, I see that. Don't worry.
Okay.
I had my cursor over a different app, but since I'm doing window capture in Discord, it still shows up. So there you go.
This is the DK rap.
Yeah.
Should we just get into it? Should I just, like, what's the move here?
I don't, like, I think we can go on. The kids
all
live,
right.
Definitely. If you're watching this later on YouTube.com/KindaFunnyGames, unfortunately, you're not getting the full taste of the DK rap. But if you watch live, Twitch.tv/KindaFunnyGames, every Saturday for the next four Saturdays right here on Twitch.tv/KindaFunnyGames, where Blessing and I play through DK64, you can listen to the DK rap in the little standby video that we've got going on. Shout out to... Snowbike Mike, in the chat, hanging out.
Snowbike Mike in chat, chilling. Off the bat, man, we talk a lot about how much we love DK64, and like, there are times where I talk about games in a nostalgia sense and talk about how much I love a game versus how a game is good.
Yeah,
I stand by DK64. Not only a game that I love, but a game that is excellent.
Exactly.
And one of those reasons, this game got cutscenes.
Oh,
like,
yeah.
Cutscenes that are,
and this
I
is
would
a good,
say,
this is
excellently
a good
crafted.
Intro to, like, the world that they have created for DK64, this peaceful island that they're all just chilling on. You've got this grand music by Grant Kirkhope building up here. It's so fucking good.
So excellent.
Oh, and it's, oh god, the way it fucking climaxes there, Bless. You need a good climax,
man.
In a song.
You always need a good climax, Barrett. Yeah, good build up, of course.
And then
King
here
K.
We go.
Rool.
the dastardly King K rule coming over. Yep.
Up to no good. This is like I described DK64 in quite a few ways. I've said before DK64 is a Skyrim of the N64.
Yes.
Because of the breadth of things to do, mm-hmm. you know, the endless nature of it, you feel like there's always that one more thing, that new mm-hmm. Discoverable quest that you yes. find along the way yes, that holds your attention, right? There's nonstop content in the way that, you know, that's how I view Skyrim.
Mm-hmm.
I would also say DK64, Metal Gear Solid of the N64, you know?
Okay, interesting.
when you get into the cutscenes, when you get into the cinematic presentation.
Oh, you're talking about the cinematic, like, nature of it. Yeah, yes. I totally get that. And there's some, there's some voice acting in here as well, which I think. Yeah, which, you know, is... varying
it's
quality.
Definitely voice acting. It definitely is voice acting. No
more. King K. Rool is definitely got a very dastardly, creepy voice, for sure. As someone shouted out in the chat, Sapphire Diamond Ruby shouted out his baby croc that he has on his lap. Like how the evil villain in like a Bond movie would have like their cat, you know?
You gotta love it.
Yeah. It's my first time seeing this game. Sorry, I was a Sega kid and then PlayStation, says Darth Archangel.
So, oh, you're in for a treat.
Yeah, you are in for a treat.
DK64 is something.
I love like the hijinks that all of his minions get into in these cutscenes too. With, like
yeah.
their big laser they're trying to like build up here to blow up Donkey Island. Or Kong Island. What do they call the island? Do you remember?
Kong Isle or something like that? DK Isle?
Oh, DK Isle. There you go. Yeah, they're trying to. Their whole motivation is just to blow up DK Isle because they hate the Kongs, and because they, I think they crash into this rock here. Their machine is kind of messed up here, so we have time to possibly save the day.
Also, I want to shout out. I'm drinking. I have like an assortment of in front of me.
Yeah,
I have, of course, my big jug of water that I always have because
stay
I got to stay hydrated.
Yep.
I have. I'm drinking tea.
Okay.
Just regular Lipton breakfast tea.
Nice.
To keep me caffeinated and awake.
Mm-hmm.
And then I also got I got that young Truly.
Oh, you got Truly. That Truly. Nice.
Yeah, for when I want to tell the truth to you people.
I've got a Coke.
And it's pineapple flavor, which I've never had actually.
Ooh,
from Truly.
Let me know how that is. I've got a good old Coke, not a CZ. Just a good old fashioned regular Coke. And then I've got on standby a mango White Claw. I'm very excited.
Oh man, it's gonna be a party. Soon in the stream.
Do we know what's up with his eye? Why is his eye really fucked up? Is that from like a Donkey Kong Country or something like that?
Yeah, I think it's been like that since the Donkey Kong Country.
Okay.
I assume.
Okay.
Chat, let me know if that's correct. Because now they think about
it. Excellency.
Oh yeah, no, his voice is terrible. It's hilarious.
Oh, this is great. I fucking love this game.
Again, the Metal Gear Solid of the N64.
Yeah, absolutely.
Chat, was what's his name? King K. Rool's eye always fucked up like that, or was it like?
Was there like a story end, beat in one of the games?
Yeah,
that,
at
like,
the end of Donkey Kong Country 3, did fucking Donkey Kong shoot him in the eye?
Now is that the same? That's the same beat to the DK rap, right? Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh my gosh. Our little parrot friend is all out of sorts right now. Now, Blessing, so you're playing, to give context to the kids, you're playing on the Wii U, you're streaming that to me through Discord, and then I'm streaming it to the kids out here. And so, when we were doing a test stream, we did a test stream a couple of days ago, just to make sure everything ran well and all that stuff. And something you discovered quickly in that test stream is that the default controls for DK64 on the Wii U was not it, apparently. But you're
no,
able to,
yeah,
to
the
map
default
all the
controls were doo-doo. But yeah, I was able to remap all the controls, and so it feels exactly right. Basically, I remapped it mm-hmm. so that it plays how Mario 64 plays on the Switch.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. So it plays just right. The one thing that's fucked up that I can't fix, I don't think, is that the camera is inverted.
Oh,
and
yeah.
I guess that's always been a thing that I just never
didn't remember that. Yeah.
Yeah, I like it was not an issue back then because I wouldn't have known better. But now that I'm an adult, bless, the inverted camera really sticks out to me.
I didn't notice it because also to give some context here, when we initially announced Donktober, there were still questions of like what we wanted it to be, how many streams it was going to be, all that stuff. We knew we wanted to do like a stream a week throughout the month of Donktober, 4 streams in total. And I remember putting out the question of like, what would you want it to look like? Just because if we're streaming 4 times, roughly 2.5 to 3 hours every week, we can only really stream about 12 hours of the game. And one of the things that I researched less was that on howlongtobeat.com, on average, people are beating this game in roughly 30 hours. And I was like, I don't know about
and
that.
And I remember it being a super long game. Like, it took me probably like half my childhood to even get to the end of this game.
And so I was a little concerned of like if we would be able to play through the entire game, get everything done to build up to you beating the game for the very first time. And so, you know, the average was 30 hours, but I was thinking in my head, I was like, you know what? There's a lot to do in this game. And I wonder how long it takes to do a bare minimum run through. And so I did that myself about a month ago to see how long it would take me to do a bare minimum run through. And it took me 12 hours flat.
Which shocks me.
Yeah. And so, but here, let me break it down for you. For you, Blessing, and for you, the chat right here. Let's see. I have it all written down. So this is the bare minimum requirements we have to get to the final level, essentially. So we have to get 15 banana medals. Do you remember what these are, Blessing?
Yes. So wait, 15 of them?
15 banana medals. And so banana medals you get by collecting 75 regular bananas for each Kong in each level. So in theory, you could do all 5 Kongs across 3 levels and get 15 banana medals there, because each Kong has their own set of regular bananas. We will definitely, we'll be very aware for sure of like how much of a collectathon this game is. We love it a lot, but we understand that there's a lot to collect in this game. So
which is like one of the reasons why I love it, but also one of the reasons why I understand people hate that.
Yeah, exactly. And so there's 15 of those that we have to collect. 4 battle crowns, which is like these battle arenas that we'll find throughout the levels. And you just like they're like quick, like 60-second. You have to survive until the end of them, kind of thing. So we got to get 4 of those. We have to get 100 golden bananas to get into the final level. I'll kind of like give you recommendations of how many to collect throughout each level, Bless. And then we have the Nintendo coin, which you get by beating the Donkey Kong arcade twice. Because the first time you beat it, you get a golden banana. The second time you beat it, you get that Nintendo coin. And the Rareware coin is we get that in Jetpack. And the reason we need the 15 banana medals is because Jetpack doesn't unlock until you get those 15 banana medals. So that's why the banana medals are important. And then, of course, the last thing, we need to do all the boss fights to get all the keys to unlock someone who will help us out along our journey who might be imprisoned right now. I'll have kind of breakdown suggestions, if you will, on what to collect for each level.
Perfect.
As we
that way, we're not wasting time.
Exactly. I want to try to keep you on track here. I want to make sure you get to the end of this game. So I don't want you wasting your time on any bullshit races too long.
Love this when you get new skills from Cranky. It'll have a name that is like Simeon Slam. Yeah. Otherwise, no one is. Whatever.
Yeah, it's like the Greek name of it.
Yeah. And I'm skipping all this just to save time. But basically, Cranky is where I'm going to go for like.
Yeah, all your upgrades.
The upgrades.
And eventually, you'll start collecting coins pretty naturally throughout the game. And
there's so much in this game. It's so ridiculous. Coins, you mentioned Cranky is where I go for all my upgrades, but the Funky is where I go to upgrade my guns.
That's true.
The Candy is where I go to upgrade my instrument. Right. There's a fairy for some reason that likes to take pictures with cameras.
We don't need to go to the fairy. I was able, I only went to the fairy eventually because I gotten so far in my personal playthrough where I was like, I haven't talked to the fairy at all. So I went over there. And that's like a total optional thing.
Interesting.
I think that's just more for the 100%ers because I think, is it for each? I don't know if it's for each fairy. I don't know if it's if it is for each fairy that you get a golden banana, or if you collect a certain amount, you get like a couple of golden bananas. I forget how that whole system works.
Yeah, let's see. Oh, actually, I don't know. Well, the crystals. Fuck. When do you get the ability to use to like collect crystals? Is that from the fairy?
Crystals are your special ability. Like fairies, whenever you take a picture of them, they'll refill like your ammo, how many crystals you have, how many times you can play on your instrument.
Crystals first like come up though in the game?
Whenever you start doing like the crazy special abilities. So like okay. DK has like his invincibility one where he's like kind of invisible and he like can like walk on like an angry Aztec. He can walk on sand. That uses his crystal ability. Diddy has like the jetpack. That's like his crystal ability. Chunky Kong gets like really, really big.
Yeah. I wonder if that's just like a cranky thing then.
Yeah, I think that's just like, that'll be naturally introduced once you get those abilities.
Gotcha.
How long are you guys planning on streaming today? I think today we're going to do roughly 3 hours, give or take.
Yeah.
So we'll be here for a bit playing the first, I would say, knowing you, because I feel like we're pretty much at the same level of our familiarity with Donkey Kong 64. I know it's been a couple of years since you last played through it. So I think we'll be able to get through these first couple of levels pretty quickly.
Like, really, the from here all the way up to probably post Toy Factory, I pretty much have down as far as like, and I know the things I need to do for the most part.
Yeah.
After Toy Factory, once we get into like Crystal Caves, you know, I can figure out.
That was definitely, it's Crystal Caves and let me see.
Crystal Caves is where things start to get like, okay, we're up in the difficulty here. Like you have to like start putting in some effort in terms of
Crystal Caves is just like a frustratingly designed level anyway. It's one of the two levels
You know what? I might have Crystal Caves mixed up with
Gloomy
the
Galleon.
Water. Yes,
yeah, that's
the Galleon.
Gloomy Galleon. Yeah.
Gloomy Galleon is what I'm thinking of. Crystal Caves also, yeah, like fucked up. both those levels I'm not a big fan of.
So we're going into Jungle Japes here. We've got one golden banana already. And so here, Blessing, we only have, you're going to unlock Diddy Kong in this level.
Yes.
And so for this level, we only have two Kongs unlocked. And so my recommendation is that you get all five golden bananas for each of them, for both Donkey and Diddy. It's 60 bananas to get into the boss fight, but I do recommend you get two banana medals. So I do recommend you get at least 75 regular bananas for each of them in this level.
Yeah, sure. Okay. We can make that happen.
And so, and another record. Oh, good fucking eye right there. I always forget about that one. Forget about it.
The amount of times I've played this first sequence of this game.
What was I going to say? God, this music is so good.
It's really good.
I think Jungle Japes, like the intro to Jungle Japes, is still my favorite. It's just such a good tune.
Oh, yeah. No, Grant Kirkhope did his thing in the soundtrack.
I forget what I was going to bring
and up. And also, when you transition to the cave and you get the cave music. I know a lot of this stuff is, you know, was started in Banjo-Kazooie in terms of, like, the style of Grant Kirkhope's soundtrack. But, like, I feel like Donkey Kong 64, I'm not going to say took it to another level, but basically expanded that. Because I think what Banjo-Kazooie has to its benefit when it comes to the soundtrack is that it's more concise and more straightforward, and it's very much like hey, you're getting a soundtrack with banjos and kazooies. Like, it knows what it is, and it's able to stick with that well, whereas DK64 feels like a more epic, like, hey, yeah, we're going everywhere. You're getting all different types of music. We're really pushing Grant Kirkhope.
There's a lot of variety in the music here. Yeah,
yes.
Absolutely. So the other recommendation I have, and I'll give you a heads up, you won't have to worry about it on this level because I'm recommending you get all of the golden bananas. But the golden bananas that I will say that you should prioritize in every level are the blueprints. So here we've got our first battle arena.
Yeah, man. I will say this is my first time playing this game on a Wii U controller, and I do feel out of my element. And so if I'm Garbo, Blame the controller, not me.
I understand, Blessing. My dad, who's in the chat and is also a big fan of Donkey Kong 64. It's one of the things we share a love for. And I gave him a Wii U for Christmas because it has like all of these classic games. I know that's what he's really into. And it has DK 64 on it. And he tried to play it, and he was just like, I hate the controls on here. Which I totally
understand.
Does
he know he can change them?
I can maybe walk him through that, but I don't know. Even with like a modern controller, I don't know if he's like super used to like how that feels. He's so used to like what the N64 controller was. So I don't know if he could like really nail that down, but maybe. Maybe we can find some configuration for him.
All
right,
so
we gotta go funky store.
This music is so good.
Hold on, let me see if I can turn this up at all.
Goes
only
so hard.
A little bit. Only a little bit.
Here, Funky is going to sell me a gun. he's a gun salesman.
So really quick, is the story true of like Rare designing their original guns to look like actual guns, and then Miyamoto was so horrified that he designs like the coconut shooter and stuff? That's not real, right? I've seen that story
tossed around a lot.
I
recall this story. Mm. Part of me wants to believe that it's real.
Someone verify that in the chat for me. Because, like, every time I read it, I'm like, there's no way they were originally intending for Donkey Kong to straight up, like, hold a fucking pistol.
Have a gat.
like I was saying earlier, for every level, the golden bananas that you should prioritize are the bananas that you get from blueprints for our friend Snide over here, who used to work for K. Rool, but has decided to turn. And if
he's like a war criminal or whatever. Like half the characters in this game are war criminals, which we like. I don't think anybody ever addresses.
No, it's never addressed. But yeah, he's switching sides, and he worked on.
He's
the
ocelot of this game.
Yeah, he worked on the machine that is being used to, or is planned to be used to blow up DK Isle. But he's lost all his blueprints, so if you collect them all...
technician on the project.
Yes.
But the double-crossing lizard kicked me off his team because he didn't trust me. I'll try to help you stop K. Rool's machine, but you'll need to find me some of my original blueprints. I'm, like, ahead of the thing.
Oh, it's actually... it's lining up pretty well on my end.
Oh, I believe they were given to some of the king's toughest cronies, so be careful. For every blueprint you return, I'll give you one of those golden bananas K. Rool stole from your hoard. No blueprint, no banana. You never know. They might just buy you some valuable time.
So here's the thing, and this
Kong.
Is...
this isn't a game, Kong. Those blueprints are vital to us both. So please, go and find some. I got you, Snide.
So these are my favorite collectibles in the game because these directly affect how the last level play out. So the more you collect, the better off you are. And that's why I recommend that you prioritize those for every level. DK had a literal shotgun at first. Okay, so I'm pulling this up from Kotaku. This shout out to Nanobiologist who got this link in here. Donkey Kong 64 originally had a realistic shotgun, horrifying Shigeru Miyamoto. This is, I gotta read this. This is from Nathan Grayson over at Kotaku.
Oh, I forgot about this.
Donkey Kong 64 stood out from the rest of the banana-obsessed Donkey Kong bunch. The DK rap is, of course, its most memorable and memeable element, but we cannot, and indeed should not, understate the fact that Donkey Kong also had a freaking gun. The coconut gun could fire in spurts, and if it shoots you, if it shot you, it would hurt. Once upon a time, though, there were no coconuts. It was just a gun. In a Donkey Kong 64 retrospective on Games Radar, creative director George Andreas reflected on the coconut gun's origins. The game was in development at British studio Rare, but original Donkey Kong creator Shigeru Miyamoto had stopped by to check in on progress. By that point, the game had plenty of standard Donkey Kong activities in place. You could swing on vines, collect bananas, and all that funky Kong jazz. But also, there was a gun. It wasn't a textured gun that you might expect, but a realistic shotgun with bullets flying out with horrifying sound effects, Andreas told GamesRadar.
That's awesome.
You get so used to things being in development, even if it is a placeholder, I completely forgot that it was in there. I'm shooting beavers.
That's awesome.
Turn to my side and see the look of horror on Miyamoto's face.
That's awesome.
Upon seeing this, Miyamoto did not emit an outraged shriek and call for the game to be canceled immediately. Instead, he began to draw on a piece of paper. In that moment, he produced the coconut gun. It had leaves on it, and he handed it to me.
Gee,
Andreas.
A gangster.
I know. Shout out to Miyamoto, who was like, ever. Who wasn't like so caught up in the moment to be like, oh, this is not the Nintendo way. We've got to cancel this game. Like, he was like, I get what they're doing here, but we got to keep it in the Nintendo vibe and style.
He's like, how can I contribute to this? That's exactly. Fucking gangster.
I looked at it and said, oh yeah, that's cool. We'll put that in. And the coconut gun was put in after that. That is hilarious. While game development was not as well documented back then as it is now, some footage of said gun made its way online, firing coconuts in one case and regular ammo in another. Regardless, it's jarring to watch beloved children's video game character and hip-hop luminary Donkey Kong murder cartoon rats with a realistic gun. Beginning to think Miyamoto might have been onto something. That is hilarious.
That's great. I know where he's at. You don't need to show me. He's in this deep, dark cave that terrified me as a kid because it was raining for no reason over here.
Yeah, yeah. Like when you go on the other side and it's like terrifying. Yeah.
And then there's like the giant beavers and it's like, why?
Yeah.
What is this nightmare?
I always pictured it as like she was like the mama beaver protecting all of her little baby beavers.
Yeah.
But yeah, I totally get that. And
so I have Diddy unlocked, by the way.
Oh, you do have them unlocked. All right, nice.
Yeah, I just unlocked them.
So yeah, your three goals are to unlock these doors, right?
I had to hit these things
right
with the gun to unlock Diddy, and so now I'm trying to figure out how do I actually unlock the doors?
Did you go up to Diddy?
No.
After he was unlocked, I think you have.
After he's unlocked, no.
Okay.
Hold on.
I think you have to collect that golden banana. That he left.
Oh, was there one that he left?
Yes.
Let's go find out.
I believe
because there was one in front of him when he was there, but I wasn't paying attention just now. So yeah,
he left something behind there that I think actually unlocks the doors. Are we gonna 100% the game or just beat it? No, we're just gonna beat it.
Yeah, we're just beating it.
We only have a certain amount of time to stream this game. Oh, of course, in the month of Donktober. Cool. There you go. There you go, bud. And so for us to 100% it would take us like 30 plus hours. There we go. Nice. You're on your way, Bless.
Now, you mentioned that like the easiest way to go about this would be to get the 5 golden bananas for Diddy and Donkey in this level.
Mm-hmm.
Am I able to do that from the get-go, or is it like, do I have to come back for them? Because
no,
I thought like,
you
aren't
can
there
all,
like, oh,
you
damn,
can do them all from the get-go here, yeah.
Okay.
If you want, you can come back later to do the other Kong's bananas here, but I never did any level backtracking in my playthrough.
Oh, you motherfucker.
You fucking dunked on, Bless.
Always like this. As long as I kept, if you keep hitting, he's gonna go down.
Yeah.
Oh, no!
So that is Diddy's specific blueprint, because all the Kongs have their specific collectibles.
A thing that very much annoyed people when this game came out, that like everything
didn't
is
mind it so much.
I loved it because it very much appeals to the collectathon like lover in my brain.
Yeah, absolutely.
Because like I think it
gives a good excuse to play as all of them. Yeah, I like collecting stuff as well, but it like making it tied to specific characters, I always thought made a good excuse to like play as them all and use all of their abilities, because there are
exactly
all fun to play as. I don't think there's any Kong in here that I dislike playing as.
And they all play distinctly enough, which is great. Like when you get Tiny,
oh yeah,
she feels tiny. Like when you get Lanky Kong, he plays Lanky.
Yeah, we can like walk around on his arms and stuff. That's so fun. Do you think they would do an HD remake of this? Ask C. Brosty in the chat.
Nah. I wish. I think this
is one that I absolutely wish that they like. Honestly, I don't even need an HD remake. I just want it on Switch so I don't have to deal with the Wii U. That's all.
Some kind of Donkey Kong collection would be great, but I don't think they would include this on it. Like if they did a Donkey Kong collection, it would be Donkey Kong Countries 1-3 and Returns and Tropical Freeze.
Yeah, probably.
So I'd wish they'd include this though.
I mean, honestly, it made me like very like when this was announced coming to the Wii U, I was happy and surprised because I was convinced at that point that Nintendo would just like never really acknowledge Donkey Kong 64 anymore. But they did in a very minor way, and I was happy with that. So we still have some sort of like modern way to play the game, but
yeah.
I just wish there was a more modern way to play the game. What about a new 3D Donkey Kong? If there was a like
again,
kind of a
I wish.
Spiritual successor to Donkey Kong 64, God, don't
oh my
even
God.
Tease me with that kind
don't
of
even,
idea.
Don't even play.
Because they'll never do it. That's the upsetting thing.
I would absolutely adore some kind of successor, but like the question does come back to like why, you know, like what's the point of unless like it, and if they did it like.
There's only three. There's four people I know who would be stoked at either an HD remake of this game, or a spiritual successor, and that'd be you, me, my father, and Seth Macy from IGN.
Seth Macy's also big into it.
I don't know if he loves it as much as we do, but I know that Seth Macy is an appreciator of Donkey Kong 64, which is why he's the only reliable personality at IGN. He's Fair. The only one you can trust. That's why.
Harsh,
it's why I left.
Came out, I was supposed to the left. Hold on.
Oh yeah.
Oh, I love this game. I love it. it's all about like, fuck. Where is that last thing that I saw that I know I can do?
Yeah. TBeaks 15 asks, did you play much of the multiplayer from this game? It's so underrated. Yeah. We were talking about that when we were doing a test stream the other day. I don't remember playing it a lot, but I do remember playing it with my dad.
As a kid, I had two N64 controllers, but no friends, and so I would play the multiplayer by myself.
Oh, bless, I love you so much, but that's such a sad story.
It's so sad.
But it was fun.
There we go.
And obviously it was fun enough that like it made Blessing want to play it.
Even oh, yeah.
I by himself.
Wait, hold on. What's going on here? Why?
You gotta get the right angle.
Why?
I'm like, you go know, out and then like come back in. Yeah, there you go.
A lot of people were telling me when I was picking Super Mario 64 back up of like, hey, you're not gonna enjoy that camera. Like the camera is janky in Mario 64. Let me tell you, man, Mario 64's camera is perfect compared to DK64's camera.
Yeah.
This camera is like, for the time, all right, but going back to it, pretty terrible. Like all in
the neither of them are great and like
ideal.
Yeah, no N64 camera situation was particularly the best.
Yeah, and that's the thing, like the thing is Mario 64's camera, going back to it, I don't have as much of an issue with it. Like I think it works fine enough for a game of that era. This game though, oh
yeah, I think right. and again I would love like a
I don't know here.
You got this, Blast. I believe in you, bro.
Am I supposed to be able to break through that?
Yeah.
This?
Oh, absolutely.
Why is it not working?
Also, remember, there is a button that I think can automatically have the camera behind you.
Is there?
I think it's right bumper.
Right. Oh, yeah, you're right. Okay.
There you go.
I
think you're doing it a little too late.
Late? Okay, let me try earlier.
Damn.
I feel like that was early.
What
is
the
there like
fuck?
A secret ability that I'm forgetting?
I don't think so. There's a dash ability? Joshua Caleb is saying there's a dash ability.
Oh, yes, there is.
Oh.
Hold on. There it is.
There we go. Gotcha.
Okay, yes, thank you for that, because I was very confused.
Oh, that's something that only Chunky can do. Fuck.
Yeah, so Chunky has to come here, but at least I opened it.
Yeah.
Cool. What is this way? Oh, it's a fairy.
Yeah, I think that's
weird game. Because they're just fairies that are chilling.
And they're not just regular fairies, Blessing. They're banana fairies, okay?
They are banana fairies. And to collect them, you take pictures of them.
And then they just exist in the picture that you take. It's never explained. It's so fucking
it's so weird.
Oh man.
All right, so I'm gonna go back here.
Oh yeah, do that. I don't think it's a race for donkey, but like there's the other ones that you unlocked over here, and I think for the other Kongs there's like a timer.
So there's the medal right there. So we did that.
Fucking easy, bro. Easy. Banana.
Please don't be timed. Please don't be timed. Please don't be timed.
Nah, it's not.
Okay, perfect.
Yeah. Right, and even, so like, Diddy's is timed, but it's, like, not that hard. Because you can also use the teleports to
get... God, it's so dark. Oh, where am I? Okay. Quickly.
Donktober? Absolutely, it's Donktober. Also, what's up, everybody in the chat? Haven't been looking over at you as much. Sorry about that. I'm just so entranced by this game. I'm just excited to hang out with Blessing.
Stone golfing, man.
I know.
Barrett, I miss hanging out with you in the before times.
I know, and here's the thing, and this is, I know it's Donktober, it's a celebration of a game that we love, Donkey Kong 64, but this is also kind of like the Barrett and Blessing show, which honestly, why hasn't this happened before?
We finally get to hang out.
I know. You'd think, maybe because we're the young ones, right? Maybe because we're the new gen, like the old folks at Kinda Funny are trying to keep us separated because they know if we come together, we're going to rise up against them.
So yeah, I just got that thing from Cranky, the ability to use that for context for people.
What's your take on that? Do you like these barrel sections?
Yes, I do.
I do. I weirdly love them.
I do for the most part. Yes. Like, I suck at them because I think I just missed some bananas just then. Yeah. But I don't need to get them because of the I already got the medal anyway.
Yeah.
But like, there's one in I think Fungi Forest that is pretty fucked up.
Oh yeah, yeah. I think it's like almost like a maze of it works.
Like, you never know what's going to be, like, the right answer for how you get there. So I have one banana left.
So do you want a hint of where it is?
I'm assuming it is this way.
I'm very proud of you, boss.
Yeah.
Trust your instincts. Oh, yeah. There you go.
And I'm also... Oh, and I'm also going to get this thing from this guy. Wait, hold on. The golden banana isn't the blueprint, is it?
It is.
Oh, it is?
So, yeah, it's golden bananas plus the blueprint golden banana for every level.
Gotcha. Oh, okay. Cool. I did not remember that, and so that is perfect. So I just got to go back to the homie Snide.
And honestly, you know what I would recommend? No, yeah, give it to him now, because you can like hold on to them and give them to him all at once.
Oh yeah,
but
do it
that
all later.
Does that like?
Well, the golden banana total you still want to build up to get to the next level and stuff.
Yeah, that's true.
No.
Okay, yeah, I feel like I was way better at going up to Snide's place that way as a kid. And I was trying to do it like a month ago, and I just couldn't do it. Just go the other
there's
way.
There's like
dude.
A. Just go the there's other the. Way. No, there's a good.
No, I know the long jump. I know what you're trying to do here. Yeah, there you go.
Boom. I gotta do them speedrunner strats. The rest of KF are boomers. That's hilarious.
Dan Riker a fan of
Third Act Bill?
Donkey Kong 64? I'm unfamiliar.
I don't know if fan is the right word. I know he has like a thing with it. Because they did a whole Donkey Kong 64 game show.
Oh, okay.
Which I bombed.
I only know Dan Riker for like liking wrestling. And like
Dan Riker I love because I feel like we have a lot of like spiritual similarities. Dan talks so much about how he loves Metal Gear Solid, and I'm like, oh yeah. And he'll talk about how much he loves Mario, and I'm like, oh yeah.
Yeah.
And then, like, he'll bring up like DK64 and stuff, and I'm like, you know what, Dan? You're on some things. You know, you got some good ideas.
Also, I just want.
I keep pressing the wrong button because I keep wanting to press B on the controller, but B is A for me.
Blessing can't see this, but I'm showing y'all my DK64 cartridge. Which I don't think is actually mine. I believe my actual one from childhood is still at my dad's house. So I may have or may not have taken this as a token gift from somewhere. And that's all I'll say about that.
That's code for I stole it from my prior place of work.
I didn't say it. Cameron Kennedy in the chat says he's less of a fan and more of a Dan. Good one, Cameron.
Oh, I get it. Yeah. No, that lines up.
Yeah.
All right, I need to get to this thingy because I want to get them coins.
Oh,
I need to
get shit.
I need to get the coins so I can get the gun so I can get into that beehive thing.
Right.
Is there anything at the top of this?
A bunch of his are on top of trees.
I knew it was fucking Donkey Kong's thing.
Damn it. It's always the wrong one. But he does have a
that
few.
Can be. I understand how you can get annoyed by that when you're climbing a bunch of trees. Also, what did I do this twice?
That's also DK's. He's got some underwater in this area. Diddy. Cool.
Fucking A.
Burgle My Bananas was the name of the giant bomb playthrough.
Yeah.
That's hilarious.
I'm going to jump into the thing real quick so I can recover my health.
Good idea. Good idea. Diddy plays electric guitar and he jetpacks. Is it possible to make a cooler character? Right, who was the one on Twitter who said that Diddy Kong was a disgrace? Was it Jared Petty? Was that another
Jared Petty. That's the continual Jared Petty rhetoric that he spreads. There it is. I was trying to do like the double jump for Diddy that he has. Hold on. Come on, you can do it.
I hate that a lot of people are popping up and agreeing with Jared here.
People don't like... I don't understand how people cannot like Diddy. He's so cool.
I know.
Jared doesn't like Diddy because he's an original product of Rare. like, Diddy was made through the Rare Donkey Kong games. And it's right. Rare is awesome. They had good ideas. What is your beef?
They made Banjo-Kazooie.
Ooh, there were coins in here.
They almost gave Donkey Kong a gun. Diddy Kong Racing, thoughts? Ask Adam Guest, 1985.
Better than Mario Kart 64. Better than Mario Kart 64. I had to make sure I was saying the right thing. I love Diddy Kong Racing. Diddy Kong Racing is a fantastic game. Hey. Barrett, did you ever play Diddy Kong Racing?
A handful of times as a kid. I was not as in love with it as you were.
It was so good.
Mario Kart 64 is my preferred kart. You can't see it, but the kids saw it. I was just shaking my head the entire time that you were saying that.
Gotcha.
Unfortunately, because, like...
to be clear, I also adore Mario Kart 64.
Yeah.
I think both games are top-tier kart racers.
What are your thoughts on Crash Team Racing? Or is that the original?
Yeah, CTR.
Yeah.
Ooh, there's more down here.
Oh, he's got coins down there. That's what it is.
I never played much of Crash Team Racing. I played a little bit of the one on like GameCube or whatever. Is it Nitro Fueled, I think? Something like that.
Yeah, that sounds right. I vaguely remember seeing that like PS2 cover. So yeah,
or is Nitro Fueled the remake? I forget. Mm. But I played that one and I didn't.
Like sequel?
Yeah, and like it was all right. I never fell in love with it.
I remember playing the original Crash Team Racing, and I wasn't in love with it.
I played I had this Lego game on Game Boy Color. This Lego racing game on Game Boy Color.
I think I had I think I had some sort of version of that on PC.
Why did I jump back down here?
Check up that tree. There's definitely a tree somewhere over there or something.
Okay, you know what? That's actually perfect. That's exactly where I want to go.
Gotcha.
I'm going to go up the tree.
It's either this tree or there's another tree in this area that definitely has nice. Nailed it.
Where the other trees?
Griffey D-Bad says Lego Racers was the shit.
See, I wish this game had better... This is going to be a fucking 2020 critique for this 90-whatever game. I wish this game had a better draw distance
98?
So that I could see from afar.
Yeah, that's fair. Definitely because, 2020
like,
problems.
Yeah, because it's like, if I could see the collectibles from afar, that would help
Absolutely. Lego Islands was also pretty cool. I think that was the one where you're like a pizza delivery person, and you get like trapped in like a... you get trapped in like jail at some point. And then you've got like a guardian angel. I have vaguely I have really weird images of that game playing it as a kid.
I need to get to the very top of this thing before I go inside.
Forget what's up there.
Oh, maybe. Is it just these?
I want to say there's
a balloon.
Oh, there you go.
Fuck, I hate this angle.
Played a way different Lego Island game than I did. That's like what I remember. Hold on.
I remember there being cocaine and strippers.
That's what Nano said. He's remembering a different Lego Island.
Showed up for a second.
Lego game, pizza guy. Lego pizza guy game. Yeah, Lego Islands. Here we go. Hold on. So this is from 1997. The plot of Lego Island. Well, there's no necessary objective to Lego Island. A special mission will occur if the player has built the police helicopter and is playing as Pepperoni.
God damn it.
What? Oh, yeah, you gotta get a...
cranky.
Yeah, you get the like head smash thing for Diddy.
Good on Beth for having that dialogue prompt there, because I feel like that is a very forward thinking thing. I would not expected that. Like, hey, let's give a hint to the player to not waste their time to like get to the. Oh, there's right. bananas here.
Pepper. Okay, so yeah, you play as Pepperoni, Pepper's caretakers, Mama and Papa Bricolini, who run and own.
Is this a Pizza Hut thing?
What?
Just like through like some kind of Pizza Hut. Partnership.
I don't know. I'm trying to look at the cover. It's just so small, though. Mistaking the caller for police officer Nick Brick, Pepper is sent to deliver a pizza to the jail, which allows the Brickster to escape from his cell by using the pizza's fumes to melt the lock. What? He escapes in the police helicopter and steals the power brick from the top of the information center before heading to the residential area on the other side of the island. The helicopter is not built. The Brickster will not be able to escape and will reject the pizza. So I do remember that. I do remember that you're a pizza guy. There's like some bad guy that and some jail involved. I vaguely remember that.
What a time, man. I miss the 90s.
Also, what year was DK64, Bless? Do you remember?
98, I want to say. 99, maybe?
98 sounds right.
99? It had to be 99?
Yeah. November 22nd, 1999.
That and Jet Force Gemini.
Damn. Wasn't that also Rare?
Yeah. They,
two games in a year? Jesus.
Yeah, two of my favorite games in that same year. and like... Oh, there's so much to do in here. Oh, boy.
Yeah, you can... To get over to... I forget what's on that ledge. Are you going to try to speedrun it right now?
No, I just thought there was going to be a thing for me to climb.
So yeah, if you go up here, there's a...
Like, jumps so high.
So if you bring out your gun, oh. Yeah, if you shoot that guy, then that'll bring up a platform for you to walk across. But you have, like, a certain amount of time, I think, to do it. So you got to be careful.
There it is. Oh, I can get through this in 30 seconds. Oh, shit, these are fast seconds. Oh! No!
Make sure oh, God. When you get to, like, the right kind of point, you can hold R and have it right behind you. Yeah, there you go. Oh, God. Oh, God! Oh, that stressed me out. All right, take two.
Let's do this again. Oh, concentration, everybody. What if I did it from this angle?
Oh, yeah. There you go.
Swear to God, B. Shit. Okay, now I'm gonna...
All right, yeah. There you go. Oh!
Oh, good stuff.
Golf claps, everybody.
Thank you, everybody. Real gamer hours here. Aha! That's what it was. It'd be great if there was just another timer. I'd be like, yo, fuck this.
Donktober's canceled.
No, we're done. We're not doing this anymore. That's like a Tamron type thing that they'd pull. Did you try out Tamron, by the way?
I did not. I've been like in a weird like kind of like mood for video games right now. It's just like I don't really know like the vibe that I'm looking for. I've really just been waiting for Crash 4. And so, like, I haven't really been in the mood to play any other games right now.
All right, we're coming up on a minecart level, which I'm very excited about.
Those are like the mini levels in this that I do actually enjoy. And these are the bees that are assholes and don't.
Oh yeah.
They drop bombs on you.
I always had trouble with this. This is going to fuck me up. I already know.
So, actually, remember, they will respawn. So, actually, like, get some stuff done in here. So, you can't go up that yet, but bring out your gun. Yeah, there you go. Yeah, get that. Oh, my God. Are you doing motion controls? What is happening right now?
I don't know what's happening.
I think it's because you're right next to the, like,
yeah, I am.
The thing. I was going to say, I don't think motion controls can be activated in this game.
I honestly, I kind of wish they could be. Because I feel like that'd help me aim better.
So you want to get out of this room now. There's another cage to go over to. Where you can make... It'll kind of be on a timer. I think it's not going to tell you the timer, but... it'll slow down those guys for you to walk on.
Oh, I see.
There you go.
Here.
Yeah, there you go. I believe in you. There we go, bless. Pro gamer moves. Yeah. Pro gamer moves. Don't forget about the gap in between these two. Yep. There you go.
Yeah, baby.
Ah! Oh, shit. Pro gamer moves right here. Let's go. Oh, you're so close. You're so close to 70 or 75.
Collect 50 coins on this pleasant scenic ride, blah, blah, blah. Someone's bro, I know the vibe.
Someone was asking if this was made first or Banjo-Kazooie. So Banjo came out in 98, and then Donkey Kong 64 came out the following year.
Yeah, Banjo was first, was this.
And so it's interesting, and this is something I didn't know. So it's interesting to go back, because Rare was responsible for so many great N64 games back in the day.
And they're the N64's best developer. Like, I'll put it out there. Aside from maybe Nintendo.
So they had... I'm trying to think. When did the N64 was 94, 95?
96.
96, okay.
Yeah.
So their first N64 game developed was Killer Instinct Gold. Yes. I don't know.
I can probably name all the Rare games, like N64 games off the top of my head.
Okay, you know what? Let's fucking do it then. You've got from 90.
I can't do it in order.
No, you don't have to do it in order, but I'm just saying you've got games from 96 to 2001.
Okay. All right. So you mentioned Killer Instinct. They did that. They did Blast Corps. They did DK64. They did Conquer. They did Banjo-Kazooie, Banjo-Tooie, Jet Force Gemini. There was Mickey's Speedway they did also. Diddy Kong Racing. Did I say Conquer's Bad Fur Day? I think I said it.
Yes.
Am I missing anything?
So, hold on. You named... 8 games. One of them was not an N64 game. Never mind. I got confused because they did a Mickey's Racing for Game Boy, but then they also have Speedway for N64. So,
gotcha.
I think you're just missing...
Did I say Perfect Dark? I think I did.
Did you say Perfect Dark? I don't think...
I might have, but they did Perfect Dark also.
Okay. And then I think you also missed GoldenEye.
Oh, fuck, GoldenEye. That's the one I should have got.
That's the one everybody knows is GoldenEye.
That's the most popular one. That's hilarious.
And
Banjo-Tooie.
I
said Banjo-Tooie.
Okay.
Yeah. Gotcha.
That's crazy.
It's interesting
to look at, like, the order in which things came out. So, like, 96 was Killer Instinct Gold, and then Blast Corps and GoldenEye.
I got Mickey Speedway, and I didn't get GoldenEye.
In one year, they did Blast Corps, GoldenEye, and Diddy Kong Racing, which I'm surprised that... Diddy Kong Racing was out before DK64. I forget how many coins you have to collect at the end of this. I want to say it's like 30 or something like that.
Might be 50.
Maybe.
I forgot. I missed how much because I was trying so hard to remember the games. I missed how much I collected. Diddy Kong Racing came out before. I think it might have came out before Banjo, and Banjo's a character in that game.
So Diddy Kong Racing. And then Banjo-Kazooie the next year. And then they did Jet Force Gemini, DK64 in 99. And then 2000, they did Perfect Dark, Mickey Speedway USA, and Banjo-Tooie. And 2001 was Conker's Bad Fur Day. You need 50. Chat has
so mad I missed GoldenEye.
Right.
I'm not going to make it.
You might. I think you still got a bit of the track left.
I might. Yeah.
And you can control your speed. If you, like, do pull back, you can, like, wait on things, you don't need to be going like full force all the time.
Oh, fucking A.
Oh god.
Give me six more, baby. No!
Oh no. Oh, bless, no!
God damn it.
That would have gotten it.
Hold on.
Alright, don't fuck it up this time. Don't fuck it up. Okay. Oh, yeah, there you go.
Alright, here you go.
Nice. Big plays. Big gamer plays.
Come on, end it now, Nintendo. Let's go.
First try.
It's definitely not first try, but I'll take it. We'll act like it was first try. They gave me a golden banana, right? I think they did, yeah. Cool. Let's go back up there and get that one golden banana.
Oh, yeah, at the very top. Yeah, how many do you have right now?
For Diddy, two, maybe? I still have, well, I got that Snide thing, the blueprint.
Did you turn it into him yet?
No, I'm not turning it into him.
So technically three?
Yeah.
Maybe four. I know where your fifth one is.
I think I know where. Well, it's in the rainy place, right?
Yeah.
The cave?
Yeah.
Yeah, that one thing.
And have you gotten 75?
Oh, shit. Hold on. How's that my second banana?
Oh.
Hold on. Okay. Well, I have the blueprint.
Yeah, you technically have three.
Okay, I'm missing one.
Yeah. Oh, I know where the
Is it in... Oh, wait. I know like the number of places it can be, because this is a very limited level, like a smaller level. Right. So I know where it probably is.
Okay. I don't want to say. I don't want to ruin it for you. Cuz I believe in you. I believe you can get it. I love all of the like complicated contraptions that Snide makes just to bring out a golden banana.
Very satisfying to go through those as a kid. How am I looking on time, by the way? I feel like I'm taking a while.
I don't know. We'll feel it out, man. It's okay. So yeah, definitely go for this one. Honestly, like, my personal hope is that by the end of this stream, we at least, like, maybe start Frantic Factory. But, like, that's not it. Like, my hope is that we for sure get through the first two levels.
We'll at least have 4 out of 5 Kongs within the next... Oh, shit. Where was it? I was not looking.
I'm gonna help you here. So, yeah, go there. And then go to the two. Go to the two coin across the way.
This one?
Yeah.
I always thought that they were like bottle caps.
Oh, yeah. That's
and then is it the
more accurate sweat? Description. Yeah, I think it's the one right next to Snide. Oh, no. It's the one down here. Yeah. Nice.
Good stuff. All right, so that's four. And then I got a fifth.
They should do other games if on the N64 they finish this early. There's no way we're going to finish this game early.
Yeah.
This is a long one.
Gonna go in here. I don't think it's in here, but might as well. Oh wait, did I get? Oh wait, yeah, I did get the.
You got that guy, and that's Tiny's guy.
That's Tiny's guy. Yeah, so this isn't it. Actually, let me make sure. Okay, so yeah, that's definitely Tiny. I got two more places that I'm gonna go. Before I'm gonna enlist your help.
Okay. All right. Zenanchi in the chat says, "I never finished DK64 as a kid either. Go finish this fight for us, bless."
I got you. We're in this together. So, I'm gonna go back here. I feel like this might be a lanky thing that I'm about to go check out, because there's like a. Oh, wait, nope, this is me. Here we go.
You're not too far off base, though. There is also a lanky thing in here.
That's what I thought. I remember messing around with lanky in here. Oh, man, it's like a gold mine in here.
Oh, no, yeah, you got bananas, coins, and a golden banana.
I am going to skip getting the actual banana because I already got the metal. Yeah. So it's probably pointless at this point. Especially because, like, actually, yeah, I can get sure this golden banana and go right into the boss fight.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. You've had enough regular bananas for a while. Yeah, definitely can elect that coin. The coins,
get the golden banana. And then, yeah. All right. Nice. So, yeah, we're about to wrap up our time here so far.
Yeah, remember, like, we did a whole intro and stuff like that. So I don't know if we really started playing the game until, like, probably like what, 12:15, 12:20.
This is what I want to give a shout out to when it comes to DK64. The characters, man, it has characters. Like, the characters are so awesome and memorable, and like, especially playing Mario 64 right before this, I think really revealed to me how different these games are, like in terms of like comparison. Because it's just, if they have very different design philosophies, where when I play Mario 64, I'm not thinking about the characters. Like, mm-hmm. I'm not thinking about the big penguin or the speedy Koopa. Like, mm-hmm. you know, they're cool. They're there. Exactly. But I feel like they don't have as much personality and pizzazz as you see in, like, Banjo-Kazooie and, like, DK64.
As you see in this hippopotamus and pig. Why are they here? Why are they hanging out? What?
Who knows? There's a big fairy for some reason. Who knows why they're there? There's a guy trapped in a cage who, like, dances every now and then. Who knows why he's there? Like, there's a bunch of different characters in this game that just add to, like, this whole feeling of this is a world that we're in.
Oh, yeah.
Which I Absolutely. Think is super awesome. But then, like, also, like, the level design of this game versus a Mario 64, and I feel like a lot of this can be attributed to Banjo-Kazooie instead, but I'm gonna talk about it in the framing of DK64. Mm. Like, how big the levels are, how expansive they are, how explorable they are versus Mario 64, which feels more contained in its levels. Like, this game just has such a, I don't know, grandness to it, and like a, like, it feels like its own world that you are exploring and uncovering as you're going through it that I appreciate. Though Mario 64 also very obviously does things that are better. Like, the movement in Mario 64 is fucking right. Incredible.
Absolutely.
I was shocked by how good that game still controls.
These boss intros terrified me as a kid, says Nano in the chat. I love it. Yeah, the music yeah. flashing, like going, like kind of hitting at the same time as the flashing at the very beginning. What always terrified me was the that you heard, like, when you go into the boss fight.
Fucking cool is this? Like, you didn't get this in Mario or Banjo-Kazooie, really.
And yeah,
everybody's
like, how
saying
the whole, like, vibe.
Expansion pack was a scam. Look what the expansion pack allowed us.
I know. Like, compare, like, visually, right? Even compare, like, Mario 64 to this, man. Like, there's just so much visually going on in this game.
Shit. Oh, no. I'm gonna die, aren't I?
You got this. Oh. I believe in you.
Ah! Damn it.
Ah! We'll wind it back. No one saw that.
That didn't happen.
That...
PS Witch in chat is saying, anyone get the DK64 promo VHS tape from Nintendo? Yes.
What is,
I very
what
much
that?
Got that, and I watched it all the time. Oh, dude, Hot News 64? That VHS tape might be the reason why I'm in the industry today. Honestly.
I don't... Also, we have to remember, so this was... What year is this? This is 99. So I was... I was 4 years old, so I barely remember things. So, like, we might have had it. Like, I just don't remember it whatsoever.
Oh, come on.
Damn. He's, like, just in the perfect angle to fuck yeah. you over on that one.
No, there was a VHS tape called Hot News 64 that they sent. That was basically a breakdown of DK64, like a promotional tape for DK64 and Jet Force Gemini, since both those games are coming out. And it was hosted by, I can't remember his name, but he was like a really energetic, it was like, he was basically a Greg Miller who hosted it and was like, welcome to Hot News 64. You know, they did a bunch of these different bits that was like a very 90s, like, oh, now we're going to, you know, we're transitioning to Cheats with Dan or whatever.
And we're like, going to the Donk Zone.
Yeah, like stuff like that.
Okay, I got you.
And I watched it all the time because I fucking adored it.
Did you ever watch the Donkey Kong show, Blessing?
Yes. So I did.
Here, I didn't know that it was a full-on show.
Is it like Legend of Crystal Bananas or something like that?
Hold on. I gotta look this up. Because I didn't know it was a full-on show, because I just had the curse of the crystal something.
Yes. Crystal Banana?
Donkey Kong show. And I just thought it was like a one-off special kind of thing.
No.
And
I think it might have been on the ABC Family.
Hold on. So, let's see here. Episodes. List of Donkey Kong Country episodes. The Legends of the Crystal Coconut, which is...
Coconut! That's what it was!
Oh, so it was like a... It was a full-on arc that was like four episodes. And I had that VHS. And man, I would watch it all the fucking time.
Yeah,
I used to love it. If either of my parents still have that somewhere. And this is the funny... Okay, so Donkey Kong Country is a Canadian-French computer animated television series loosely based on the Nintendo franchise. Donkey Kong, as portrayed in the Donkey Kong Country video game series by Nintendo and Rare, first aired in France on September 4th, 1996, during a block called La Planète. Donkey Kong, translated as The Planet of Donkey Kong, and aired on Teletoon in Canada in 97. In the United States, it was one of the first series to be shown on Fox Family, in which the series was broadcast in its entirety from August 15th, 98, until 2000. It was also seen on Fox Kids from 98 to 99 for a very short time, airing two episodes as specials on December 19th of 98. That is just, yeah. So I remember watching the Legend of the Crystal Coconut arc. Apparently, because that was four dedicated episodes to this one story.
Donkey Kong looks so awkward in that thing too.
They all look fucking weird. Like, even like, it'll pop up if you don't know what we're talking about. Even if you look up Donkey Kong in like GIFs on Twitter, it will pop up.
The memories of going to the Fairy Island and being like, "What the fuck is this?" What is this for? And then realizing that if I get tiny and turn tiny, I can go into it.
CDJ Gamer says, let's watch the whole show.
Dude, let's do it, honestly. I'll do a watch along.
That would be a really fun, like, drunk watch along of the Donkey Kong Country show. You know, speaking of drunk watch alongs.
Oh, is it time? Are we doing this?
It's White Claw time, Blessing.
Oh, man. Let me open up this Truly. Oh, my God.
Oh, yeah.
Spray everything. All over me, all over my face. Oh, my God.
Oh, no. Bless. Don't get it all over you.
My chest.
So we were kind of talking through the first time that we came in here, but this is Kay Lumsey, which is Kay Rule's brother, I think.
Is that what this is?
I'm pretty sure Kay Lumsey is Kay Rule's brother. That's the vibe I always got, but I'm not too sure.
I really like the name Kay Lumsey. I guess that would line up. Because they have the same naming scheme for the names.
But don't have the same last name, I guess. Because technically his first name would be Kay, and then his last name would be Lumsey.
You think they're really thinking that hard? Because like Diddy Kong and Donkey, well, I guess Kong would be the last name.
Yeah, they have the same last name. I don't know. It's deep lore, it's me, John P. It's the crazy dude. Let's not even get into the whole Donkey Kong Wars thing. Do you know about this stuff, Les?
No.
Oh my God. So maybe we have to get into it. Hold on.
Yeah, Donkey I want to know Kong what that is. Is that like? War. Oh, is that like how like Cranky Kong is the Donkey Kong from the original game? And like,
hold on. Where is this? I gotta find it, because I can't do it off the dome of like what this whole
the Kong Kremlin War World War. I've been thinking a lot about this, because obviously there's a thing going on with
the
these
Great
guys.
Ape War, sometimes called Kong Wars, Banana Wars, or Kremian War, was a war between the Kongs and the Kremlings, alluded to in the various Donkey Kong games. And events are thought to have taken place sometime between the classic arcade game Donkey Kong 3 and Super Nintendo title Donkey Kong Country in the timeline's lore. However, it's never often directly spoken of.
I'm wondering about that.
Yeah, so they do kind of a breakdown of the Kongs here. So, like, Funky Kong was known as the Brown Baron for being the greatest pilot in the war, though he lost his tail after General Klump shot him down during a dogfight. So I think that barrel that you just unlocked is one for Tiny, because I think she can do a little spin. Because I did fuck around for a while to try to get in there as Diddy, and I could not do it. All right, so we're going into Angry Aztec, Bless. Do you want to hear my breakdown here?
I want to introduce us to these ghosts. These fucking terrifying ghosts that give you hints in the levels.
And I think these ghosts also play into the Kong War. So they give you, like, hints and stuff. My may have passed since DKC3, but I'm here in spirit to help you defeat those naughty crocodiles. Oh, my God.
Like, what were they thinking? I love it.
I don't know. They were just on an acid trip.
They were doing some drugs making this game. All right, give the breakdown.
Okay. Angry Aztec, my recommendation here is we get 14 golden bananas, two banana medals, so just two of the Kongs collecting 75 golden bananas. You need 120 to get into the boss fight. So
shout out to the fact that the last boss we fought is named Armadillo.
I know. They're so good at their naming. It's too good. It's too fucking good. We're unlocking Tiny and Lanky in this level. Across all four Kongs, 14 golden bananas. I would recommend four of those being all of their respective blueprint golden bananas. And then I recommend only two of the Kongs need to get their banana medals in this one.
Gotcha. This is where things are gonna start to get complicated for me. Because the level design of this level,
it's definitely a little It's a little more spread out, but once you get the full picture, I think you'll get it.
It's somewhat hard to, like, get a grasp on what's what, too. Like, especially having played this game as a kid, like, there are multiple things where I'm like, okay, I don't know where this is. Like, there's a structure on this side of the level that looks exactly like a structure on the other side of the level, and it's like, I don't know which is which. And
just they're both just places to collect bananas, you know, golden bananas.
True. All right, so it's time to meet Candy.
All right, I'm glad that we're here, because I need this on public record here. I forget what happened during the January streams, but I remember at some point, I'm very drunk.
Oh my God.
I remember being very drunk back in January, and I don't remember fully how the conversation turned a certain way, but at some point people were like, why does Barrett have the hots for a child? I think people thought I was talking about Tiny Kong or something like that. But I was trying to reference Candy Kong. I was too drunk to really make my, like, argument here. But, like, being a kid and looking at, it's like the Bugs Bunny when he dresses, like, when he cross-dresses and you're like, oh, it's like the,
Bugs Bunny when he cross-dresses, not Lola Bunny?
There's the funny joke from, what's it called? Wayne's World, where Garth is like, they're like thinking, he's like, did you ever, like, you know, like, think about Bugs Bunny whenever he cross-dressed? And this is kind of like that, a similar thing, where it's like, she's a monkey, it's but she's, like, weirdly hot as a monkey, a cartoon monkey, and I'm just gonna be, like, I feel like people were judging me back in January, trying to explain this. It's like, I'm not attracted to her now. She's a ridiculous, over-sexualized cartoon monkey. But as a kid, you're gonna, like, turn your nose up at young Barrett, who was like, why does she have really big boobs? What is happening? Why is there sexy music playing on in the background? Candy was purposely very sexualized.
Why are Donkey Kong and Donkey Kong, like, trying to, you know?
And don't fucking judge. I know all you nerds, like, your big titty anime girls out there. So don't you fucking judge me. Don't you fucking judge 5-year-old Barrett Courtney. Okay?
To be fair, those are all humans. Also, the anime.
That's true.
Most of the time.
That's fair.
Some of the time.
But I just wanted on record that this is Candy was the one I was talking about, because I think because I was just so drunk, I didn't remember her name, so people thought I was talking about someone else.
Tiny or what's the one from DK2? I forget.
Oh, shit. Dixie Kong?
Dixie, yes.
Yeah.
Oh my god, I got the hiccups and the burps from the Truly.
Hell yeah. Yeah, you do.
Man, she is talking. All right, here we go.
And it, like, even like the way she talks, she's like standing a little closer and stuff like that. And she does it to everybody, man.
I want to know what Tiny Kong's, if Tiny Kong has a similar thing going. Because I forget if she's like, if she's just normal or
she's a normal, like, I don't know if she's supposed to be like a kid or something, but like, she's in like, I don't know, like overalls and she's got a beanie.
Well, no, I'm talking about Tiny Kong's like reaction to candy. Because you know how like when all of them go in a candy shop, they're like, standing, posing.
Oh, they're all like posing and stuff. I think she does a pose.
I think she does.
Yeah, but I think they all do kind of the same pose, no matter who you're talking to. Like if you're
Tiny is a woman-loving woman queen, is what I'm understanding.
Okay, yeah. If that's what you want to take from that conversation, then yes, sure.
I'm so happy.
See, this would. Well, I guess even if you had a better, what were you saying earlier? The draw distance. Even if you have a better draw distance there, you probably wouldn't have been able to see which instrument it was until you got there.
Again, I know for a fact that guitar doesn't do the thing that I think it would do, which is free the camel. The guitar does not do that. The guitar is probably going to open up that door, I think.
Yeah.
To like the rest of the level.
Oh, it does. Yeah, you got to go cranky for that. And that's Diddy's crystal. So yeah, the crystal abilities start getting introduced in this level. So yeah, the guitar opens the door.
Because like it's on top of the llama, so you're like, oh, okay, let's free this llama real quick. But you play it, and it's like, no, that's not what it does. And as a kid, I remember being so conflicted, or not conflicted, so confused, because I would forget that I used the guitar to open up that thing. And I would come back, and I'd try to figure out, like, how do I free this llama? Like, how do I do the llama thing? And I keep playing my guitar, wondering why it's not working.
So before you go over there, go back to that that building structure over there.
This guy over here?
Yeah.
Yeah, I was thinking about it. Ooh, yeah. Because
you also got some coins, and you got that, I think you got a balloon to pop over here. And that teleporter, yeah.
Oh, yeah, baby.
Nice.
Okay, this guy's going fast. Hold on.
There's some crazy fast ones later on, man.
Yeah, no, they really put that joystick to the test.
Was this game considered good back in the day? I do not remember liking it. No, you're definitely in the majority. Which, like, here's like you and I have talked about this. That, like, I didn't know people didn't like this game until I joined the industry.
Yeah, same. I didn't know people didn't like this game until I started listening to podcasts.
Yeah.
It was a slow realization of, like, you know, anytime DK64 was brought up, people would either, you know,
scoff at it
or, like, you know, change the subject or whatever. And like, at a certain point, I was like, people not
like this game? Yeah, I remember saying it, like, kind of.
What conversation we're having?
I forget, like, why it was brought up, but I remember kind of saying, like, loud and proud at IGN at some point. Like, oh, yeah, I love Donkey Kong 64. And I was ridiculed for it. Ridiculed from everybody. Like, Per Schneider.
It's not fair, man.
It's
not fair.
Who else? Who else was always, like, giving me shit for liking that?
Jared Petty?
Jared Petty gives me shit for a lot of different things. So it's hard to, like, really remember which one's which.
Chunky.
Fran, I think. And I just felt like, what happened to the world where everybody started hating Donkey Kong 64?
It's like, why? And I think the thing that I put together is that I think it is in context of DK64. Hold on. I hate these guys.
The teeth suck.
Yeah. Sure. I think it's in the context of DK64, one, coming after Banjo-Kazooie and being so similar, where it's just a way different, like,
More intense Banjo, right?
Like, it is a more, it is an expanded Banjo. Like, it is them being like, all right, Banjo-Kazooie was a hit. What if we took one of Nintendo's IPs and made a bigger Banjo-Kazooie with multiple characters and all these different features and all these different collectible things? And I think it coming after Banjo-Kazooie, which felt just way more concise and way more just like, I guess, controlled. Mm. Like that, I think that probably rubbed people the wrong way. And then also, there are collectathon elements in this game that just take things too far. Like, I couldn't count like the amount of collectibles that are in this game. Like between the crystals, the film, the watermelon for your health, the bananas, but like the different bananas for each of the characters, and then the golden bananas, but also golden bananas for different characters, the banana medals, and then you got the blueprints. But then you also have to take pictures of the fairies, which are also collectibles.
Yeah, I don't know how many fairies there are.
Yeah, did I mention the blueprints?
Yeah, you did. My dad said, don't succumb to the gamer insider herd mentality for Donkey Kong 64. I forget, is it 200 in total of golden bananas?
I thought it was 100.
No, it's 100 to get into the final level. But I think that's only like half of the golden bananas.
What am I missing, Barrett?
I don't know. You did it earlier.
Oh. All right, it was just being finicky.
Okay. 201. It's 201 golden bananas. People are confirming in chat. If we do the math here, let's see. 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30, 35, 40 blueprints, 40 banana medals. I don't know how many battle crowns there are.
That's a good question.
Yeah.
Also, fair to point out, also with the collectathon thing, right? You're also collecting those battle crowns. There's also the Nintendo coins. Oh, shit. All right. Camera so, back.
Yeah. There you go. There you go. I believe in you, Bless. There you go. There you go. Oh, yeah. Get all those bananas.
There we go.
Fuck
we're
yeah.
in there. And that's going to melt the water.
God, his instrument is the coolest. Again, how can you hate on Diddy Kong, man? Everything about him is so cool.
People just don't know how to be cool, is what I'm understanding. Right, so that's going to melt the water, which is going to let me get to Tiny. Is there a starfish in this one, in this water? Or is it the other place?
I think it's both, honestly. The starfish suck.
Because the starfish terrified me as a kid.
Yeah, they had really, really fucked up faces.
And, like, you couldn't kill them, which is, I think, the main thing for me.
Yeah. Yeah, because you can't really...
Oh, shit, he's here.
Yep. Oh, shit, he's coming.
I hate this guy. I do like that you can swim forever, underwater forever. Like, there's no, like, drowning. Because monkeys apparently have gills.
Yep, that's how it works.
According to DK64.
I think this is a lanky thing. Yeah.
Oh, because the water gets... He's in the water.
Yeah.
But there is a way to get... Did I take a wrong turn? Is that what I did?
Yeah. Oh, this is where you go to when you enter in straight. So I think it's either your left or right.
I need to turn up the brightness somehow. Oh, here we go.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Tiny has 6 bananas in the outside mainland. Oh, so that's what makes it 201. Because Tiny has an extra golden banana in the overworld.
Ah, shit.
Gonna bounce for a while. See you later, Zhao Mama. Drew says, I don't know why my Twitch app didn't let me know you guys were on. I forgot about this. I was just listening to XCast, and I was like, oh, shit.
That's why you gotta make a calendar.
Yeah. Also, yeah, I've been noticing, like, Twitch notifications have been kind of weird and wonky lately.
So I gotta spell out Kong with my gun.
Nope. You're close.
Not with my gun?
You're close, though. Go back over to where you found the coins.
Wait, who's still alive? Where are you? Ah! No! Fuck, okay. Where I found the coins?
Yeah, next to Tiny.
Oh! Oh, okay.
What's up, Third Goat? What's up, Wolf Fox? TV says, spell out dunk.
Right.
What's Someone's saying in the chat, 665 gigs for PS5 day one. Is that true? Seems really low.
665 gigs? Ooh, that's not good.
Yeah. Oof. Big oof.
That. Wait, where is that from? Like, where's that information from?
Yeah, I wanna try to verify that. PS5.
These guys are tall.
SFD space. Apparently it's coming from Reddit. Some leaks.
Oh.
Let's see.
I'll believe it when I see it.
It's been a bonkers 24 hours for PlayStation 5 rumors. We're getting your live reactions of this of these rumors here. As first images of the next-gen console's user interface have allegedly leaked, but we've been unable to verify their authenticity. Among the leaks is a video game is a video of the system's startup sequence. Images. Oh, interesting. Sorry, they've got like a GIF in here of like the startup.
Things are leaking, basically.
Yeah, among the leaks is a video game is a video of the system startup sequence. Images that suggest the consoles will include 664 gigs of usable storage space and more. However, it could all be a big hoax. I mean, to be fair, PS4 launched with 500 gigs. So, like, they're technically just like the base PS4 going into the PS5. Yes, there is a bigger space there, but I feel like with like how much has changed since the launch of the PS4, I still feel like that's low.
Well, yeah, that's the thing is the games are getting bigger.
Yeah.
And like storage is getting more expensive. And so that is a net negative.
Yeah.
Like you would think the especially for like a $500 console.
Right.
Storage would be at a terabyte.
Someone said,
or like at least like 800 something, right, with operating space.
I don't know, understand the science behind this because I'm an idiot. But someone, a dark protagonist in the chat says games will actually get smaller with SSD. No, I don't know about that.
Because we got the size.
I'm only saying like, I don't know just because I'm dumb and I don't know how that technology works.
The thing that like essentially comes down to developers, right? Like if they want to actually do the work to compress their shit. And like we got sizes for a few games that like seem to be pretty on par, right? Like Miles Morales and Demon's Souls, I think, was in the 60s, which is I think pretty on par what you'd expect.
Yeah.
God, this game needs a brightness setting. Everything is so dark right now to me.
Hell yeah. We got some coins over here. Nice. Did you already see Candy with Tiny?
No. Okay. I should do that. Actually, let me go see.
Yeah, go collect a bunch of shit.
I'm going to see Cranky in a second.
That might be actually where you just were.
Oh, am I going too far?
I think you're going too far. Yeah, it's probably a good idea to see Cranky first. Now that you have coins. Oh god.
Leave me alone. There we go.
There we go. Mental note that there's DK coins over there. Yeah, go to the left here.
Aha.
Yeah, there you go.
Yeah, there it is.
These like fixtures on the wall here that like kind of looks like demonic faces always freaks me out.
Oh, same. Are you kidding me?
What is that shit, man?
This game is terrifying. At least it was for me as a kid at times. Ugh.
You got this. I believe in you. You're so close. So what does he give you on her first upgrade? Oh, yeah, the kind of double jump that she has. Double long jump.
I perfect another.
So how does Blessing feel that Travis Touchdown is a Mii costume in Smash, asks Arkwing24. Blessing, how do you feel about that?
Oh, it's the thing that'll make me smaller. In the words of Drake, I'm upset. There's a Drake song called I'm Upset.
I just thought that was like a reference to every single song he puts out. But...
I...
So maybe you already have the spinny thing.
I tried to do it before and it didn't do it.
Oh, you might unlock that in the third.
In the next level.
Yeah, you definitely have to have that before the boss fight in the factory, because that's her boss fight.
100%. All right, I'm going to switch to Donkey Kong real quick. In fact, I might have enough coins.
Get everybody out here.
Yeah, because I have 8 coins, so I'm going to get something else from Cranky probably before I do that.
Yeah, definitely get Donkey and Diddy out there, because you still have to unlock the Diddy's jetpack.
Yes.
Which is also so cool. Again, I don't understand how people can be on the side of this weird war that we have.
He's like, and here's the thing. I'm going to say something that is not going to be to the benefit of my argument, but I'm going to stand by this whole phrase. All right? Diddy is so cool. He is like the Sonic the Hedgehog of Donkey Kong. And for some people, that's going to make complete sense and reinforce my point. To other people, they're going to be like, that makes them less cool. But you know what? I stand by it.
I hate it, but I get what you're like going for here, but I hate it.
He has so much attitude.
CDJ Gamer says Lanky is the Sonic. No, Lanky is not the Sonic. Lanky is his own entity of just absolute batshit weirdness.
Chaos. Lanky is legit like chaotic evil energy. Chaotic neutral. Chaotic good.
Jump into so this is the invincible ability.
The crystal.
Yeah. Ability.
Cool. And then hopefully maybe I have enough coins with Diddy.
Good to see you guys taking up the mantle after Andy announced his retirement, says Kason Live. Did you see Andy's twit longer last night?
I did see it, yeah.
And like the second I saw it pop up, I knew immediately what it was about. Because like an hour before he tweeted that, he came out to the living room. Alyssa and I are hanging out with Lulu, and we're watching some show. And Andy's kind of like looking around. And he's like, "Hey, I think I might have spaced out a little bit earlier." And I was like walking around the house with like the controller for my lights, and I don't remember where I left him. So we helped him look around for it, and we were not lucky after kind of searching the general areas of the apartment that he would have been walking around. And an hour later, he was like, the end of an era. And I knew immediately, I was like, this has got to be about the fucking controller really that he can't find.
That is really funny.
Oh, man.
Also, I hate that this is supposedly quicksand, but you get hurt as soon as you touch it.
Yeah.
Like, that's not how quicksand
works. You do also sink into it. But I also do, like, there isn't, also, here's the question, though. Shit. Have you personally dealt with quicksand ever in your life, Blessing?
Outside of video games? No.
Is there a pain that you feel, like, when you hit it, though? We have to ask someone who's ever dealt with quicksand.
You imagine no, right?
Oh, Kazen Live says it's hot quicksand. There you go.
Oh, yeah, I mean, I guess that would explain it away. Yeah, it's hot quicksand.
That's like galaxy brain thinking right there.
Yeah. But like Mario 64 got that right, where you go into the quicksand, and there's two types of quicksands. There's the bad quicksand, and there's the badder quicksand. And like, in the bad quicksand, shit, I'm sucking right now. In the bad quicksand, okay, let's see Tiny's pose.
I think she's just like kind of like this. She's like,
she's cool.
She's just fucking chilling, man.
No, I think she's into candy, though.
You're thinking that they're all into candy.
1000%. That's why they're posing so cool, is because like they're talking to candy and they want to like, you know, put on that swag, that swag attitude. Tiny is doing it, which I think confirms that Tiny is into candy. Tiny is a bi queen, or maybe just a woman loving queen. We stand Tiny. That's what I'm saying now.
Of course we stand Tiny. Tiny is fucking great. But like, here's my question, because we got to dig in even further here, Blast. And I hate to say it, but just stick with me here. If they're all
in I'm looking at a thing in chat that is making me very concerned.
Where do you see this?
Is Tiny related to candy? And I guess that brings us back to our conversation.
So again, here's the deep dive that I want to get into. They're all Kongs. It's Donkey Kong, Diddy Kong, Tiny Kong, Lanky Kong, Chunky Kong, Cranky Kong, Funky Kong, Candy Kong. And so, like, there's a poster of Candy Kong at Donkey's, like, little house. So, like, are they dating? What's going on there? Are they, like...
We have pictures of our family members sometimes in our homes.
It's a full-on poster on the wall. of her full, like, it's not just like a nice portrait. It's her full body on a poster, on his wall, right?
Is that normal for monkeys?
So are they, like, kissing cousins? But here's the other thing. If they're dating, isn't it also kind of weird that, like, all of, like, the other family members are also into her?
I mean, no. Because, like, you can be into somebody that your family member is dating. It's not appropriate. You shouldn't. Like, that's the thing you shouldn't do.
But is it weirder when, like, your family member is dating another family member and you're into one of those family members?
That's when it definitely becomes a big problem. But, again, my question comes back to you. Is it a monkey thing? Do monkeys date relatives? Is it normal for monkeys?
I don't know. Nano says, I'm so close to unsubbing because of this conversation. Good. That's what Donktober is all about.
Hey, step, bro.
God, I hate it. These are the hard-hitting questions that we need to not be afraid to ask.
Step Kong, I'm stuck in the dishwasher or whatever.
Greg Miller has been out there reporting things over the last, 15 years, but he hasn't been hitting the hard questions, you know?
Well, yeah, because he's not been paying attention to the Kongs. He's been on that PlayStation beat. Didn't even realize all this incest was happening on the Kong side.
Zyger says, Donktober is about unsubbing. Did you guys tell Greg Miller about this or nah? We've taken over. Donktober is about whatever we want it to be about now.
Okay, well, apparently this is the level where there's no bananas on any of these trees. All right.
I think Diddy or Donkey have a
gun. Oh, you know what? I can get a gun. If I have enough coins. Do I have enough coins?
Maybe not. Yeah, follow that line of bananas that you just passed, though, because I think that'll take you to some coins for Tiny. So I think that's the last thing that you need to unlock for Tiny, abilities-wise, in this game. In this level, at least.
The gun.
Yeah.
Crossbow.
that shoots feathers. It's so dope.
It's really cool. I want to, cosplay, a Kong. But I feel like that might get into weird territory in terms of... never mind.
You don't want to bring it up?
No, I don't want to bring it up. I don't want to go down that rabbit hole. Like, why is Blessing dressed up as a monkey at this con? Is this okay?
Oh, fuck. How big is the Kong clan? I'd imagine the name Kong is like saying Duke of Earl, name of location. That's an interesting idea. Is Kong like are they all called Kongs because of where they come from, not because they're all related to each other? You know,
but like they're from DK Isle. Like, is Donkey Kong?
Wasn't like it Kong Isle? What is the name of their home?
Kong? I thought it was DK Isle. Maybe it's Kong. I don't know.
I searched up Kong Island, and I got the result Kong Skull Island, the 2017 American monster film directed by Jordan Vogt Roberts.
Okay, so this is a Donkey Kong thing.
Yeah, so that's how you unlock that's how you free the dude.
Oh, by going in there and doing a thing?
I think so, yeah.
I thought you do it by, going through that thing three times.
Oh.
Did he?
You might be right. You might be right. No, that's the house where he
is. I think Lanky's in here, right?
He lives. Lanky is in there. The first thing you need to do is do that thing with Donkey, that little thing where it shoots you up to the barrels. Because once you do that, I think that wakes up the
yes. Thank you.
That wakes up the thing in the middle, and then you can go fly around as Diddy. Yeah.
You're absolutely right. No. Oh, I forgot that she fights with your hair.
It's so cool.
Ringer's on another level. Like, look at that.
I know, dude. She fights with her pigtails. That's so dope.
The character animation is immaculate. Like, come on. Let's have some respect on Rare. Put some respect on Rare's name.
My dad is discovering that you get timed out for spelling woe incorrectly in the chat.
Oh, that's hilarious. Is that an Andy thing?
Yeah, I think that's an Andy and Joey joint, I believe. Because they are very adamant about the correct spelling of woe.
I disagree with their spelling of woe. It's
thank you.
H at the end.
Wait, what?
W-O-A-H.
Thank you. Thank you. I'm not against their way of spelling, but I take it personally that they're so hateful against the alternative way to spell
it. They're adamant that the other way is wrong.
Because in my chat, when I'm streaming over on twitch.tv/adboybarrett, I don't block any version of it. Yeah, there you go. Oh, so that wakes him up. Oh, you know what wakes it up? So what wakes up the monument is flying through the golden thing 3 times. That's what wakes him up. And then you have to shoot peanuts into his mouth. And I forget what that gets you. That might get you a golden banana, but I'm not too sure.
Okay. There's a lot going on in this game.
I know.
So this level specifically, there's a lot going on in.
Yeah.
I appreciate it because it's all interconnected.
Yeah, and I appreciate this one because I think, even though it's only the second level, I think this is where the connecting of different parts of the level get really complicated. And I'm glad that they kind of introduced that early on. I will say Toy Factory is definitely a mess of how that layout is. I definitely got lost in Toy Factory a couple times.
All right. Okay, so we have feather here. And then the grape or whatever this thing is, grapefruit. So
those are grapes for Lanky.
My thing is above it.
Yes. Yeah, Lanky is unlocked here. Did you get Diddy's jetpack yet?
Yes.
Okay, cool.
Yeah, I did all that in one fell swoop.
Nice. That's the best when you have like all 5 of them and you just go and you're like, all right, let's just get them all of their upgrades.
Yeah, let's knock this out. All right. So I remember the llama has this is funny. The llama has to spit in the pool. Oh my god, get away from me, you coward.
It aren't like llamas things that they spit? No, like a thing they do.
Yeah, no, they spit. But apparently, this llama spit turns lava into water.
Is this llama Jesus? Instead of like turning wine into water, he turns lava into water.
That's pretty funny, actually.
Again, there's a lot of lore to think about. Why does the hippopotamus and pig just hang out at that boss area the entire time? What do they do when we're not in there? You know. What's going on?
Wait, what are you?
I'm not trying to insinuate that there's a sexual relationship. I'm just wondering what they're doing with their lives outside of, you know.
I guess that is a good question. It's like, what is y'all's purpose?
They're just like hanging out in front of the door. I want to know what they're up to. So I forget how
you blank that thing.
I'm getting a Norton life update. My computer is protected by Norton Life. Then I get a bunch of annoying pop-ups all the time.
That's a thing for Tiny.
That is one of the first aggravating races, I believe. So I think Donkey has an instrument thing in here that'll wake up.
The trombone is Lanky, right?
Yes. He's got the long arms, right?
He does have the long arms. Oh, I never put that together. That's why he's so good at the trombone, is because he has those long arms. You know what they say about folks with long arms? They say, damn, them some long arms.
That's exactly what they say, Blessing.
Here we go. Leave me alone.
I hate the purple ones. So that's another one they have to do with bombs, I think.
Yeah, okay, or the instrument. Yeah, spit.
I don't like how you said it, Bless. I don't like how you said that. I'm not a fan.
I love it so much. Spit into that thing. Oh, man. I love you. Might marry you.
Oh, Christ. So I think you have to go in there as Tiny? No, maybe not.
That's right. This is an easy one. He's literally just right here.
Oh, yeah.
Turn. There we go. Was he doing push-ups?
I think so.
That's awesome. Shit-tech. He's like doing
push-ups. Chatek, I'm sorry, I'm really bad at reading Twitch names. Says spit for me, daddy.
Oh yeah.
Coco's Revolt says was watching XCast and heard Barrett talk about them playing DK64, so I came to Twitch and it's happening. See how that works? You love to see cross promotion between all the shows. Shout out to Snowbike Mike who let me do that. Yeah, he like asked me like right before we were recording. He was like, "Hey, can I throw it to you to shout out Donktober?" And I was like, "Absolutely, Snowbike Mike."
If you're watching this, go download an episode of First Impressions. You know?
Exactly. Seriously, look up First Impressions on podcast services around the globe. Please subscribe to it, rate it, listen to a couple of episodes. Even if you've watched the video version already, just listen to a couple.
Yeah. We're trying to build something here.
We're in the Empire. We're not in the meth business. We're in the Empire business.
We're not in the games media business. We're in the Empire business. Oh, fuck. I'm going to do all the things with Linky, aren't I? Like, go get the guns and all that shit.
Zyger asks, but what if I want to listen to Debatable? It's the same RSS feed. You just got to scroll back.
Scroll back.
Because
I don't have... Yeah, I got to get the things.
Is this the DK64 First Impressions? No.
No, this is a stream.
We would have had to record that like 15 years ago for First Impressions, you know? To play it for our very first time and like give our first impressions of the game, you know?
I mean, has Greg Miller ever played DK64? We can make him play it for the first time.
He's such a fake gamer. He's never even played Halo before. What the fuck is that shit?
What kind of gamer is Greg Miller?
I don't know.
He played Halo.
But he'll play whatever game he can to get a platinum trophy.
Catapon.
Shovelware. Ugh.
Won't even finish Persona 5 Royal. Alright, so I gotta get coins so I can get the gun and I can get the abilities and I can get the instrument for this guy.
Right.
Oh, where do I start with that? I love this guy. Alright, so, okay, off the bat, boom. They know what I need.
I think he can't run, but I think you can do his handstand ability.
No, I can't.
Maybe not. Okay. I guess that's a cranky upgrade.
I remember that thing changing the game when I got that ability.
And then when you can run, when you like jump into the box and you can like fucking sprint.
Oh yeah, we just sprints on his hands.
Yeah, so good.
I've always wanted to be able to do that. All right, I know. All right, so I got my pea shooter. I want more grapes.
All right, this one?
I don't think I can get there yet, right?
Yeah, you can. You just
How?
Need the. You shoot the doors, I think.
But I don't think there's anything. Is there? There's not any. I think you open them. You gotta do some weird shit to open these doors.
Okay.
I suck at walking in this game. All right, let me hop back here so we get some health.
Tell you bless. This White Claw hit pretty quick.
Oh, did it? You feeling it? Are you feeling it, Mr. Krabs?
I'm feeling it now, Mr. Krabs.
Back here. Maybe there's gonna be
people are terrified by Lanky Kong for some reason. He's great.
Really?
I love Lanky
Kong.
He's
so sweet. I love Lanky Kong. He's a weirdo, but like harmless. There's some Donkey Kong coins in here.
Are you going over to Cranky?
I'm just trying to find coins.
You might find some coins in that big building in the first area.
First area?
Yeah.
I hear some bananas.
Ooh.
Oh, on the way to Lanky, too. Oh! You know what? In the first building, I'm going to call it the Llama building. Fuck, I hate this shit.
I know.
Like these narrow
really
paths.
Narrow paths, like.
Because it's not like this game has fantastic control.
Yeah. Camera control, like specifically.
Camera control, like, yeah. God.
Yeah, I feel that.
I'm gonna get there anyway. Get that. Get that shit.
Nice. There you go.
Get this shit. No. Go back. Cranky, what's good? So yeah, once I get this, I think I'll still have enough coins so I can get the instrument, and then I'm gonna go back to the llama.
Okay. Also, Dad brings up a good point that you can hold the camera button to have it like stay like directly behind you as well. Because that is the best strategy to go along those like really narrow paths. Someone was saying like if we realize that my mic overtakes Blessing's. Yeah, unfortunately, if like we talk at the same time, just because of how Discord works, Blessing will start sounding weird. I'm trying my best to like try to not speak over Blessing, but I'll try to be better about it. Or if you're saying that I'm just generally louder than Blessing, let me know. I definitely don't want that to be a thing.
Yeah, I bet you it's largely a thing of Bear's capturing on his side and is probably capturing his camera through OBS, which means that that's probably going to overpower Discord. All right, so we're back at this first area. Let's see how Lanky poses for Candy.
I think this is just another goofy pose.
Yeah, see, he's being all cool.
I love, like, he's doing, like,
they want to fuck her.
He's...
they want to get it in. Like, they want to get in those guts.
No! God damn it.
Blame the Truly, I'm sorry.
I just love, I love he's doing like the cool pose with the arms like across the chest, but his arms are just so long that he's just kind of hugging himself.
You gotta love it.
Why is this so sexual all the time for no reason? That's Donkey Kong. That's Donktober for you.
That's the game, man. This game is just a sexual game. We don't think about it that often. We don't look at this game as one of the more sexual games on the N64, but it definitely was. Like, it was this and the ending of Mario 64, like, the most sexual moments of that console.
How did Mario 64 end? Why? Was that super sexual? I don't remember.
I mean, it was how I played it.
God blessing.
No, Peach gave Mario a kiss on the nose. Mario's all like, wahoo! And it's okay, bro, put your boner away, please, Mario. It's showing. We can see it.
Okay, if that was it, okay. I was trying to think if you were trying to make it more than it was, or if there was actually something I did not remember from Mario 64.
Oh, shit. There's a golden banana right here. That's probably DK, right?
I think that's DK, yeah. It's official, DK64 is the horniest Nintendo game, says Doc Figaro.
100%.
Olive Party gestures to all of Conker. Isn't Conker like very, like that's like very.
Cinemaniac says, I don't think any of them want candy. I think Blessing is projecting. maybe you're projecting, you know? Maybe you're the one that wants candy, Cinemaniac. All right. I feel like
just deflected now, Bless.
I'm very obviously deflecting. I feel like DK64 walked so that Conker could run when it comes to sexuality, of course.
Gotcha. Like, they had to take the first steps for Nintendo for Conker to really be able to go all the way with it.
Oh, yeah. Because like Candy is basically the hot girl from Conker.
Nano says this gives a whole new meaning to the song I Want Candy.
Oh, wow. That's a great pull.
God.
All right, I'm going to go back to that building in the second part of the map.
What? Have you listened to the Funky Monkey Love remix on YouTube? Kong in Concert, Funky Monkey Love. I've never heard of this. I'm kind of terrified. Kong in Concert. There's a kind of funny Games Daily topic. Horniest game on each console. That definitely Games Pass topic. God. We should pitch that to Tim. Horniest game on each console.
I mean, I feel like BMX XXX definitely has that console. Like,
what console is Galgun on?
Vita?
Yeah. I feel like that definitely wins.
Persona 4 is also on Vita.
I've never played Persona 4, so I don't know how horny it is.
I mean, it's like as horny as Persona 5, pretty much.
Yeah, but Galgun, you're like literally... Isn't the whole premise that you're like shooting girls? And then they like...
And then like they have orgasms?
Yeah.
Oh, there's a Donkey Kong thing right there that I missed this whole time.
Damn.
I wonder what that does.
Galgun actually just got announced for Switch and Xbox One, Barry. Of course, I knew the second I brought up Galgun, Zyger in the chat would fucking like just what explode with excitement to talk about it.
Like, well, actually. Galgun came out in the year 1996. Oh, shut up, guy. I hate this purple guy.
He hates you, too.
Yeah, no, we really don't like each other.
According to the Donkey Kong Wiki, Lanky Kong's arms are 7 feet long. Lanky Kong's arms are 2 Nick Scarpinos. Good one, Tiger. You know what? You won me back. After the Galgun love, I was like kind of questioning it, but you brought me back with the...
That's really good.
With the Nick Scarpino bit there.
How much time do we have left? Okay, we got an hour left still. We're making decent time. We're going to get to Toy Factory.
I'm looking at, like, the list of levels here. So, if we do... Yeah, that might be possible. That might be possible.
All right. Yeah, how do you think we're doing on time?
I think, overall. So, I'm looking through the levels here. So, we've got Jungle Japes done. Angry Aztec we're in the middle of. I'm confident that you're going to be able to get it done. We got Frantic Factory, Gloomy Galleon, Fungi Forest, Crystal Caves, Creepy Castle, and Hideout Helm. Those are all the levels before the final boss. And the final boss, depending on how many times it takes you to try it, shouldn't take too long.
Oh, I'm one-shotting that guy, trust me.
So it's 8 levels. I think if we go maybe a little longer on our last episode here. Because on average, if we can do 2 levels a stream, I think we should be pretty good.
So this is like a sound puzzle, I think.
It is. It's essentially... I should be quiet.
Oh, man, this is going to take me forever.
It's like in the memory game thing, yeah. As a reminder, you only need to get 14 golden bananas on this level. So if you want to skip this one, you totally can.
Okay.
Nailed
so I got
it.
That. The aiming is also like
it's,
the aim
it's,
sensitivity.
It's sound but also color, so I think like yellow, like there's 4 yellows, so like 2 of them match together. And
oh really?
Yeah,
I never put that together. Okay, this actually okay, that's gonna expedite the process then. Shit, they're respawning.
Kevin would hate this game. With all the burps.
Kevin doesn't like burps.
Yeah, he hates burps. I accidentally burped at one of our meetings like a week ago. And he was...
Oh, yeah, he seemed very uncomfortable.
He was very upset. And I only burped because I thought my mic was muted.
Out of all the things Kevin to hate, I feel like burps is a weird one for him.
I know. He's fine with farts. He's fine with the sound of farts. But he hates burps. I don't understand it. Wasted Bandwidth asks, is this a Destiny puzzle?
It does feel that way, doesn't it? I like this game.
It's so good, man.
Oh, man.
Hell yeah. Ew, someone's asking me, have you 100%ed this game before, Barrett? I have not. I'm trying to think of, like, probably the most I've ever done in this game. Yeah, I don't even think I could tell you, like, the most amount of, like, golden bananas I've collected in here. Like, maybe 120?
Did I get Tiny's Tiny ability? I think
you
I did.
You did. Yeah, that's her first one. And then the one she gets from Frantic Factory is the spinning.
Gotcha. Okay, so I'm gonna ignore the fairies. Yeah, I know. Wait, did I run the right way?
No, I don't think so. Yeah, you're still in that same room.
Oh. It's because it's so dark.
And the camera angle's all fucky, too.
Yeah. Why is it so dark on this monitor? Okay, here we go.
Yeah, turn up your monitor.
Yeah, I might have to just do that.
All right, now you can unturn.
No, this is me now. This is me now. I'm just kidding. There you go. Wait, you're blue.
Ah, but there's a warp coin there. What is your T Beaks 15 asks, what is your favorite Donkey Kong game for each of you?
I mean, not including this one?
Yeah, if we're including this one, it's this one. Yeah. There's a reason we're streaming this one. It's because it's our favorite. This is my favorite one. I will say the best Donkey Kong game, though, is Tropical Freeze.
I still got to play Tropical Freeze.
Oh,
I've been wanting to play it.
Oh, bless. Tropical Freeze
I'll
is
love
so
it.
Good.
I love me a 2D platformer.
Tropical Freeze was like that kind of moment where it felt good to finally be into a game that was like Donkey Kong Country, because I didn't play those much. I did play them as a kid. I didn't love them, though, just because like a lot of like my enjoyment out of things is like being into like the art style and stuff like that. And I definitely wasn't into the art style of the country games. And so I just like just as a kid, naturally just like wasn't really into them. So it was cool to, like, finally be into a game that was like Donkey Kong Country, but, you know, having, like, modern art assets and stuff like that. And it's also just, like, a fucking great, like, it's such a well-designed game. It's great. It's one of the best platformers, I would say, in, like, the last decade.
I really love Donkey Kong Country 1. When I originally played that game, I have an interesting experience with that one because I played a lot of it at a friend's house because I had a friend that had an SNES. I think I talked about this recently on a show. But like I owned the game on Game Boy Color. And so like that was kind of how I originally like played through that game was on the Game Boy Color version.
Gotcha.
But I also want to give a shout out to Yooka-Laylee, even though it's not a Donkey Kong game. But yeah. it's a rare game.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yooka-Laylee in the Impossible Lair specifically is really good.
I haven't tried that one yet.
It's so good.
I've heard really good things about it, yeah.
Did I beat it? I got very far in it.
Before you leave here, you should go over to the llama to switch over as Lanky.
That's what I was trying to do. Okay. Oh, you know what? I can probably use this thing.
Oh, she also might have an instrument in here. I forget, though. Don't forget, Lanky has an instrument in here as well.
Oh, you're right, he does. Is there a two?
Noah Ohm says Yooka-Laylee in the Impossible Lair is a game of the year 2019.
I really like that.
That's quite a statement right there.
It's so good. It does a thing that I wish more platformers would do, which is take advantage of the overworld. And, like,
I vaguely remember you talking about that. Back in your OKBeast days.
Especially coming out of Mario 64, I realized that that's the thing that game does that's so special is it creates, like, it uses the hub world in really interesting ways that affects the actual levels.
There's an actual relationship between the hub world and the levels themselves.
Yeah, like when you jump in, when you're going into wet dry world, if you jump in like at the top of the painting, the level or the water starts up high, right? Versus if you jump in the middle, the water starts in the middle. And like, you know, there's like a thing in Big Tiny World or whatever it's called, where like you have two paintings you can jump into and like you can go back and forth between the two levels. Mm-hmm. You have the clock world. Why can't I find the bottle cap I'm looking for?
I think you passed it.
Is it on this side? Oh, it's right there. But yeah, like the TikTok clock level, you know, like depending on the time of day you jump into it. Depending on the time you jump into it, like that'll then determine how fast the gears are going level. Like cool things like that. Yooka-Laylee in the Impossible Lair has a similar thing, not as necessarily like cool as Mario 64, but still like still fun. Like I like how they utilize that stuff.
And really quick before you leave here, turn back around. Yeah, because he's got an instrument thing in here, I think.
Oh no, I didn't want to do it.
I think it's in this room.
Fucking A. All right, here we go. Let's play some music.
I hope Playtonic makes another go at a 3D platformer. I feel like they learned a lot since the original ukulele, says Nella Ohm. I'd be down for that. I never checked out. I remember...
Is this our first, like, bonus level?
Oh, God, yeah.
Let's go.
You sure?
Oh, definitely.
Okay. God, I love his handstand. It's so good.
Yeah, man.
Oh, there's also a Tiny Kong banana thing there.
Oh, okay.
Keep the turtle spinning by feeding the snakes melons. Press A to fire them out.
I already know this is about to suck.
This isn't even the worst one. Because there's like the fly swatting one. There's the one where you have to herd all the beavers into the hole. That is the worst one. Because there's something weird with like the... Like you have to like... They can't directly fall into it. They have to like kind of like walk alongside it to like fall in. And it's the most bullshit thing in this game. That's why we avoid those. We try to avoid those ones at all costs, but no, eventually.
Yeah, this one's actually easy.
Yeah, that wasn't too bad. XJPZ123 asks, did anyone have that Star Wars Shadow of the Empire game for the N64? Absolutely. I love that game. You play as Han Solo's friend. It starts off in like the Battle of Hoth, and you're trying to escape while the rebellion escaping and stuff like that. That game was dope.
I'm here. Because I know Lanky has some shit on the other side. If I can remember how to get there.
Oh, you just
I gotta turn up the brightness. Hold on. I cannot see shit.
It doesn't look terrible. It's like definitely dark, but I think that's like, this is the brightness the game is intended at. But yeah, you might just have a darker screen.
Oh, wow. My brightness is literally all the way up on my monitor.
Jesus.
And I can't really see anything. Okay.
All right, hold on. So you're at one wall. The entrance is at the bottom of the opposite wall.
I gotta get rid of this menu. All right.
Yusuf asks, can this motherfucker drown or not? I'm very confused. No, they all have gills. So we were talking about that earlier.
Yeah, no, the monkeys can breathe underwater somehow. It's never explained within the lore, but
To your right. Nope.
Wait, like this way?
No. You're looking the exact opposite direction, I think.
So this way.
90 degrees more to the left.
This way.
Yes. At the very bottom center. At the very bottom center. I can see it. I can see the entrance.
Yeah, I'm looking at the screen. Now I'm looking at like my Twitch stream, and it's like slightly, I can see a little bit more.
There you go. I will kind of fault the game for that. There are parts of the game that are like naturally just like way too dark, but it's crazy. Like how, like, what are your like monitor settings? Because that's crazy. You can't even see it. All right, there you go.
Slightly too dark.
Think you've done everything you can.
I kind of want to do. I feel like I'm doing too much, but I kind of want to get the balloon for Tiny.
Where's the balloon for Tiny?
At the top of that thing.
Oh no, I got
like over.
Well, you do have to get at least, let's see here, 120 golden bananas, but two golden. Or two banana medals for this level, so you gotta get two Kongs to collect 75, so it's not a bad idea to try to do.
Where am I at with? Okay, well, she's at 40. If anything, I could probably get the key from this level if I wanted to, or not I can probably go to the boss fight right now if I wanted to, because I think I have
probably
a lot of bananas.
Yeah.
Oh, I guess only Lanky could go up there.
Yeah. You still might be able to see it at the entrance. Like, try aiming your gun like right here.
Wait, did I never get the gun? I don't think I ever got the gun as Tiny.
Oh, man.
How many coins do I got? All right. Well, let's get you a gun, Tiny. That's really funny.
Dad is saying that we need her spin jump for the... Yeah, probably from the camel, you do her spin jump over to the top of that... Yeah,
that lines up.
That makes sense. Yeah, we won't get that until the next level.
Do I have... Okay, I do have enough coins.
Nice.
Oh, you know what? She does the same pose here.
Yeah, again, they're all doing the same pose, man. They're all just trying to be cool. I don't think they're all trying to fuck everybody, okay? All right, Blessing.
Maybe she's bi. Or pan.
Or maybe they're just all friends and they just all want to like hang out and be cool together.
Like,
it's not all about sex, Blessing.
Like, look at, like, Funky is built. And his name is Funky. Like, you know he's a cool dude. You want to hang out with him. Yeah, Karmic in chat is saying that she's hot for Funky. I agree. Okay, let's figure out
Rokan
what...
2108 says, I mean, I'd fuck Funky.
Alright, so we got 40 little bananas for Tiny, okay. 46 for Lanky, 45... 67 for Donkey. So Donkey, I should probably
you should wrap up him, and then it's a toss up between the other three right now, honestly. You know, you should. The next thing you probably should do is all of the stuff with Diddy, with the monument thing.
Because
I feel like there's something with that unlocks a couple of things, and I forget what exactly.
Let's do it. Oh, you know what? Okay. I have vague memories of some shit.
Because I'm trying to, get you to the point where
you
can...
go through the thing three times. That then unlocks, like, a race. That's what it does. It unlocks a race with... I forget who.
Yeah, it unlocks a race with, like, a vulture. And it's not even really a race. You have to, like, just follow him around.
Yeah.
But you can't fall too far behind.
Also, yeah, the trees
music when he's, like, doing the jetpack shit is so cool. But there's also something that you unlock when you feed him. Like, he starts opening and closing his mouth, and then you have to shoot peanuts into his mouth. Oh, you barely... Oh, my God.
I barely made it.
This whole chat needs to go to horny jail, says Noah Ohm.
Are folks getting it in?
People are getting really horny for Funky.
Yeah, everybody's saying that they'd fuck Funky. And I agree. So I gotta find him.
Yeah, he's essentially at the place where you do the jetpack, where you get the jetpack. I'm trying to figure out how to unlock that, unlock that one building for you, because that'll definitely have bananas and stuff.
I think I need to get on top of the building.
Oh, yeah.
With Diddy, maybe. Try again. Sure. Alright.
So I think he'll give you an infinite amount. You just got to make sure to keep up with him. So you can't. It's something like you can't get like two behind or something.
Don't underestimate my flight skills, ostrich, whatever the fuck you are.
Oh no! Oh, there you go. I think he's a vulture. I don't know. You get a consensus? No, he's got like a weird beak. Oh no, bless.
I'm here, Daddy.
Don't call me Daddy. It's weird.
I didn't mean to call you Daddy. I just meant Daddy like a just like a figment, like an idea. You know the. Just the general idea of Daddy, you know.
The Daddy was the friends that we made along the way.
Exactly. Nice flying, Diddy.
Nice.
Now let's what I can find. Oh, really? That's it?
Huh. That's not too bad. Oh, banana. I don't know what it is, but Nano clipped out something that says Bless reveals his kink.
Oh, no.
I think it's probably you calling me daddy. Yeah, so go to the top of that tower over there. I wonder if he's got like an instrument thing on top of there.
Yes, sir.
Oh, nice.
But I think every Kong has their own thing. Yeah. I think every Kong has a banana in this yes. building.
It's an easy place to collect bananas.
Oh God.
Feed I like me. That.
Oh, so yeah, you have to feed him to unlock the. Okay, this is. I understand every once in a while. people's frustration because they've really stretched out unlocking this building a little too long here.
But I kind of like it though because it does feel like a quest chain in like a Skyrim.
Yeah. Okay. Yes, because this is the Skyrim of
the N64. Yeah.
Yes.
God, I can't believe I'm still here this far into the stream. I feel like I should be past this by now.
Dad says, need to practice flying, comes in handy later. I mean, pretty much all he's got to do is, like, really practice, like, the stabilizing thing, right? Which I forget what button that is.
Wait, is there a stabilize button?
Yeah, there's, like, a button to, like, so you can, like,
Oh, yeah, Z.
Nice, there you go. Maybe a little lower. Oh, there you go.
Fucker. No, come on, son.
Nice.
Let's go. Oh. Oh.
There you go.
Okay. Cool. Sweet.
I knew that must have been it. It's like there's no way they.
Yeah. No. Okay. I hear you now.
Yeah.
That is annoying. that's the thing that unlocks all of those things.
It's an unnecessary step. I think it would have been fine if we just found Diddy's thing on top of the building.
Was the thing.
Yeah. I get that they want there to be like a physical challenge thing that you gotta do as well. But
that's
like
that's pretty
funny. This is like a little much. Aim in the same place one more time. Let's see if it works.
Okay. All right. God, this terrifies me, honestly.
Yeah. It gets really scary once you get to the golden banana.
Oh, sorry.
Ooh. At least they don't time you on the way in. That's my one thing.
Wait, what do I hear right now?
That motherfucker. Yeah, big guys.
Okay, so there's the golden banana.
Nice. All right, you ready?
Yeah,
you let's got do this. This. It's easy. It's easy. I believe in you, Bless. 5, 7, 8.
Get out.
Oh, God.
Oh. Oh, fuck. It's too late.
Oh, there's a fucking... Damn, he's close, too. You can just go back in. You can go back in after you. Just run out. Just run out now.
Get out.
I know. It's terrifying, man. So you have 8 golden bananas. My recommendation is 6 more for this level. And to, of course, get the 2 banana medals, which you are close to. With both Donkey and Diddy.
Cool. I wonder if there's any more if I go this way.
Yeah.
Oh, no!
Oh, God.
Oh, I hate them.
They don't blow up, though. Because there's blowing up ones, too.
Yeah, there are. In whatchamacallit? The Galleon place.
Yep. Gloomy Galleon.
Gloomy Galleon. Sweet. I can just run all the Kongs through this place.
Bless, what the hell did you say on PS I Love You? Is it pets? Anyways, put this game on Switch, damn it.
Yeah, port everything to Switch.
Port everything to Switch.
Yeah, they should put this on Switch.
Well, Squid Girl, they blew up because Blessing threw a A grenade of them.
Yeah. They're by themselves. Yeah. Like, they're suicide bombers, basically.
Like those dudes that we just saw, like, they come at you and they'll just hit you. But then there's special ones that are in TNT cases that will, like, come to you, like, run to you and, like, blow up themselves. CDJ Gamer asking, where's Persona 5 Scramble at? Oof.
$1 million question.
Yeah. We still never found out what, like, our pizza bet was on that. I don't even know if we made a pizza bet on it, but we made, like, some sort of predictions for that.
But I remember being very, oh my god, no, these are the guys. These are the guys that blew up.
Yeah, those are the TNT guys. There you go.
You fucked.
Nice. Oh my god.
That's pretty.
That's
graphic.
I know.
It's kind of scary. Oh. Damn it, I don't like these guys because, like, I can't. It's hard to aim at them.
Yeah, I don't like any enemies that you have to use the bomb against, just because, yeah, there's no good way to aim with the bomb. Dad says, I usually don't like water worlds in games, but the water world in this game flows. Boo.
Gloomy Galleon?
Yeah. Oh, well, he's trying to make a pun here, because that's what my dad does. He goes into Twitch chats and just. Yeah, go to the other side, see if there's a. Maybe some bananas. There you go.
I like that. Like, that's just an ability you can use whenever. Wait, is this the same way? That's the same way.
Yeah. So
it's like it's like the Team Blast from Sonic Heroes, except you can just use it over and over again, which is nice. Okay, so it looks like there's nothing here.
Oh, you know what though? I do know of a place that there's another place that Donkey has.
Is this the place that you need to get the invincibility?
Yeah, there's an invincibility area that you can go to.
Yeah, because I have that opened.
Okay.
Oh!
God, it's terrifying every time. Like, you definitely have plenty of time to get...
Shit my pants. Get out. All right, so that's two. I have Tiny and Lanky, I think.
That is saying, but seriously, I do like Gloomy Galleons. That's one of the few levels I do not like in this game is Gloomy. And the way they separate the areas just, like, becomes really frustrating in that level specifically.
Yeah, that level was definitely, like, a stopping point for me. Like a
because there's so much back and forth going on.
I was stuck there for so long.
Yeah.
Also, like, that's the place where, like, Cranky starts making some demands that I just couldn't keep up with. Cranky's like, all right, enough with the coins, I want blood. And I'm like, wait.
Yeah, I think that's when he starts introducing the thing of like, hey, I want a certain amount of...
I forget what it was. He wants something that's not coins.
He wants the banana medals. He wants the banana medals, because once you get 15, then he'll give you jetpack. Yeah.
Is it tiny voice?
Dad says, what I'm trying to say is this water world is awesome. You guys are wrong. Shark swimming. Dad, if you're a true Donkey Kong 64 fan, you would know that Lanky turns into a swordfish. Okay? Come on, so dude. You're embarrassing me out here.
So this place has a little bit more involvement to it. I feel like there's a bonus barrel in here.
Yeah, I think there's a bonus barrel at the very end of this world. I don't know what this takes you to, though.
Oh, this is nothing.
Oh, this is just collect a...
Oh, wait. Hold on. This doesn't seem right.
Just seems like...
Oh, I can't go on...
Yeah, because there's no way...
Okay, because I was like, wait, wouldn't there be a way to go back small if this is all I could do, but...
Yeah.
Shit. I like that move from Tiny, this one. Okay, there's a fairy in here.
All right, you don't have the camera, so yeah. Might as well go back.
Do the fairies don't give me golden bananas.
I think it's like if you collect a certain amount, and you go back to the main banana fairy. She'll like give you some or something like that. I forget.
Oh my god, I hate these guys.
I know.
Okay, so there's that. What's on the other side? Just a coin. Did he just kill himself?
I think so. That's fine. 10 bananas now, so just 4 more to go. And still 2 medals. I'm trying to think of other Diddy areas that you could go to. Because you're really
love
close.
A good Diddy area.
God, okay.
Alright. I couldn't resist. Okay.
I'm sorry to abandon my post, but I do really need to go to the restroom because this White Claw really kicked in. So I will be back. As soon as possible. Entertain the kids, Bless.
What's up, kids? How's it going? What do you guys think of Donkey Kong 64 so far? Is it? Do you guys think it's dog shit like the world would want you to believe, or are you watching this and going, huh? Doesn't seem that bad. Also, how did I miss all those bananas as Diddy? What's back here? Okay, well, here's some coins. I don't like all these things that are just hidden back here. Doug Graham says, doesn't seem that good. I appreciate your honesty. Let's see here. Blast Core is really good. That's probably like the one rare game on N64 that I didn't really try. It's Blast Core. All right, Lanky, let's see what you got for me. E-shooter. All right, I can hear them bees throwing things. No, I wanted to bring up my gun. Brought the instrument. As a kid, I used to say hoopla with Lanky when he said it. Hold on. I'm trying to figure out, when did he say hoopla? Oh, hoopla! Okay, I see. When you just jump. There we go. Oh my god, that thing is speeding. Here we go. Yeah, baby. Oh, shit. Did it come back? Hold on. Did it just really disappear? Here we go. Right here. This should be the place. There we go.
Okay, I'm back.
Oh my god. Dude, you scared me.
This is a reminder for context. Blessing cannot see my camera at all. So that is fucking hilarious. Oh, I need to do that more. I need to go on bathroom breaks more just to fuck with you.
I forgot you were on the stream, to be honest. I was over here vibing by myself.
Oh, man. That's great. All right, Blessing, I have something I need to talk about here that's been kind of weighing on my conscience for like the last couple of days. So,
all right, here's the level I was talking about.
Oh, yeah, here we go. Which one is this one? Oh, this one isn't terrible, but it still kind of sucks. It's not as bad as the hurting one, I think.
Two. And you see two more.
You got 50 seconds. You're good. There's one where it's like you got to get like 8 or something like that, and it's crazy.
Oh, dude, I killed that.
Golf clap. Golf clap, everybody. Golf clap.
Thank you, everybody.
I'll wait for you to do this. Get out.
My god.
let me go here. So I was doing research for a project this week, Bless. Mm-hmm. I was doing some, like, trying to find some, like, actual, like, specific sources. I was going through, like, Wikipedia to get sort like, see, like, what their sources for this specific project was. And it's funny because, like, this Wikipedia page that I was on had Greg Miller's name in there, and it linked to Greg Miller's Wikipedia page.
Oh.
I popped in there because it's, like, I think it's fun and cool that, like, there's someone that I know who has a Wikipedia page. And then, naturally, Greg's links to the kind of funny Wikipedia page. I was like, oh yeah, I'll check this out. I think I've only looked at this page twice, maybe. I think the last time was probably like a year ago. And let me read you the kind of funny, like a kind of breakdown to the right where they have like the box of info, right? Industry, entertainment, genre, comedy, video games. Founded January 5th, 2015, 5 years ago. List of founders, headquarters, San Francisco. Services, online video, community website. Members, Kevin Coelho, Andy Cortez, Joey Noel, Greg Gettys, Blessing Adeoye Jr., Gary Whitta, Imran Khan, and Mike Howard.
Wait, what?
What's wrong with that list, Bless? What's wrong with that list?
Well, first of all, I'm down to welcome Snowbike Mike into the family. First and foremost.
Well, but to be fair, like Snowbike Mike is like a part time host, right?
Yeah, and so that
similar
that
to Gary out. And Imran. Yes.
Was your name on there?
No, it was not.
Oh, damn.
And that's where I'd say. So I'm pretty sure the last time I looked at this, like a year ago, my name was on there. My name was on there at one point, and and it's hazy, so it might not have been. But I swear I remember looking at this and being like, oh, shit, it's cool that my name's on the Wikipedia. But it's no longer there. And so I feel like someone actively went into the Wikipedia for Kind of Funny and is erasing me from the history of Kind of Funny because of some hot take or another that I had, probably.
I like the idea that somebody went in just to add me, and they saw Barrett, and they're like, no.
And then they also actively put in Gary, Imran, and Mike, who are part time, like kind of like guest hosts or whatever you want to call them. And I'm a full time employee, motherfucker.
That's funny.
It hurts.
To be honest, I have no idea what I'm doing with this.
This
is gonna raise the tower, which sounds like a euphemism, but I promise.
I mean, at this point in this stream, like, at this point, it's not.
Yeah, DK64, one of the most horny games. Oh, whoa.
It was a horny game. God damn it.
Oh, look at that.
At this point, I can't even, like, deny anymore that it's a horny game. Also, there are bananas on top of all these trees right here. So yes, I think that'll get you to pass the threshold for Diddy. And I'm going to say, we might go just a little long. I do want to get you to the boss fight.
I'm vibing.
Yeah, we vibing here. And that's what Donktober is about. Horniness and vibing.
Exactly. Those two exact things. Oh, there we go.
Nano said this is a weird way to find out you were fired. Oh, God. I can't believe.
Yeah, after Donktober, that's when it's all over.
I can't believe Tim did me like that. He canceled party mode and KFAF, and now he's fires me? Damn.
Damn. All right, I need the jetpack to get up there, I think.
Yes. And then Tiny can go up there, but I think if my memory serves me well, I don't recommend.
That's the race.
I think that's the race, and it's like not a good one. It's like a really frustrating race.
Low key, I kind of want to do it.
I will let you try it once, but we can't waste too much time on it.
Oh, yeah, I see what happened.
Yeah, that unlocks her saxophone. So you have to turn into Tiny Con. Like, Tiny has to get Tiny and then run over to her saxophone. And then that'll get the vulture dude or whatever to come and pick you up. Or maybe just the parrot, I forget.
I'm going to get these coins as, what, donkey?
Yeah.
Yeah, baby.
Big brain plays right here.
Oh, and there's some bananas right here. Oh, man, let me get some bananas. Are there any more bananas? Where am I for bananas? Oh, I'm at 70.
Oh,
so, yeah.
You're so close.
I'm right there with Donkey.
Okay, hold on. Also, how many bananas, golden bananas does Donkey have? If you do, yeah.
Three.
Okay, three.
So
did you get his
blueprint? Did I get the blueprint?
No, you didn't. The blueprint is at like the very beginning of the level in like that first entryway. In that like hallway.
Gotcha.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, I'm going to do this thing as Tiny real quick.
You're going to regret it. I promise you.
Oh, I am. I know for a fact I am, because I remember struggling here.
Tim is canceling anything not HD enough. Am I not high definition? No, that's like the joke, is that Tim canceled KFAF.
Oh, I gotta be literally tiny for this.
Yeah. See, she's got her little barrel. Right now, KFAF is taking a break. It's not actually like cancel. Doc Figaro said, edited the wiki to include you, Barrett. Thank you. I was just trying to make a goof out of it. Can you also add in there that I'm just, like, in general, a pretty cool guy? So maybe people will believe it. I feel like if it's in the Wikipedia, people will believe it.
All this is just do a race that I'm not going to win.
Yeah, and it's the, I think it's a, it's the Beetle Dude, and it's like a sliding race. You're, like, sliding down.
Yep.
Ugh. Yep, fuck this one. I think this took me, like, I ended up doing it.
50 coins.
Oh, God. All right. I know you're going to get, like, every time you lose, you're going to be like, all right, just let me do one more. I'm telling you now, you get 3 tries with this fucker.
Oh, and he hit. Oh.
Yeah, he fucking hits you, man.
Oh, you son of a bitch.
Yeah, dude. He sucks. It better say Boss Daddy Barrett in the Wikipedia.
The soundtrack.
Also, if you
though.
Fall off once, you also. Yep. Which is also right. The very frustrating thing about this is that you lose.
Just one more.
What is with rare and bullshit races? Seriously, says Raisin and B-Man. Were there bullshit races in Banjo?
Probably.
Yeah.
That sounds like it's correct. There are races in Jet Force Gemini.
Mm.
But actually, those races are pretty good.
Okay.
Because you can race, like, aliens and, like, speeders.
There was a race at Goldeneye. It was a foot race.
I can't tell if this is a joke.
It is.
I
wasn't confident enough to, like, really keep on with it, but I was going to try to convince you that there was eventually a foot race in, like, one of the later levels of Goldeneye.
If you said it with enough confidence, it would have been like, damn, Rare loves them races.
I wasn't in the right mindset to, like, really do it just because I'm a White Claw in, so I feel like if I was sober, I would be able to pull it off, but. All right, you have, what, 18 more coins left? 14? Okay. Oh! All right. This is your last try.
Dude,
before
I
we
had
go.
It.
You did have it. You get one more try though. Then we got to move on. This is a part of what makes this game great. Super challenging, says Dad. No, this is like this is like bullshit challenging kind of stuff, I would say.
I mean, I kind of dig this.
This first one with the beetle isn't terrible. There's another one with the beetle where it's like absolute horseshit. And there's like the water race with Lanky where he's in like the water boat.
Yeah.
There's another one too. There's like a different character that I think you race against. That I think is also like really bad. Or no, I think you go against the beetle with Lanky, and you have to do, like, the really fast, like, running with Lanky on the handstand.
You know what? There is a fucking A. There is a race in Fungi Forest with Lanky that you do. That is, I don't think it's the beetle. I think it's another character.
I think it's a
that
bunny
you are, like,
in the Fungi Forest.
Yeah, I think it might be. All right, I'm going to dip out of this.
All right. Proud of you. Proud of you for being the...
I wanted to do it again, but...
Bigger man. And walking away.
All right, I should change to Donkey so I can get the rest of those bananas.
Ooh, yeah.
I'm thinking if I go to that cave... The invincibility cave, there are probably going to be bananas in there.
Did you unlock that ability?
Yes.
Yeah, okay. When did you open this cave? I don't remember you opening this cave.
It was when I was in one of the buildings.
Okay. Yeah, there's his barrel. Next stream, Blessing to do just the races. Says Gene to Davis.
I'd be so down.
You would go insane at the end of it, dude.
I like that challenge. All right, here we go.
You're crazy. There you go, yeah. Oh, and then, boom, you've got balloons for Diddy in here. I don't know how you get... Oh, I think you have to jetpack in there as Diddy.
That makes sense.
Yeah. Oh, this is the sneaking one. I hate this one.
I don't see shit.
It's too dark. Go right. All right, I'm going to have to guide you. Right.
Here we go. Oh! Oh, no. Okay.
You can make it. You can make it. Yeah, I trust you. All right, you got this. You got this.
This is Metal Gear Solid, what I said.
That's true. You're not wrong. And now there's like a stealth portion. All right, go back. Go back. That's a dead end. It's a dead end. No, that whole area is a dead end. So go back the way you came.
Nah. Who are these guys?
They're like security guards.
Welcome to bonus stage.
They call it a bonus stage, but like they're part of the core bananas.
I know.
It's like there's nothing bonus about.
More right. There you go. And I would say. Keep going straight, or go left a little bit. Yeah, keep going straight here. Go left. Damn it, dead end.
How do you see this better than I do?
I don't know. All right, go right. It might be my brightness settings on this specific, because I'm looking at it in Discord, and it's pretty dark in Discord as well. Or not Discord. Yeah. OBS.
On stream?
Yeah.
Because I don't see shit. I am walking
around. We might need to pass this one up.
Yeah, we might just skip this one.
I think I only ran into one or two of these my entire time, so.
I'm down to just go directly to the boss, if anything.
Because
how many did you suggest we get in this level?
Yeah, pull up the menu here.
Yeah, I got... Let's see.
3, 5, 9, 12. So you need two more golden bananas.
Five.
Which I think you could easily get with. And then you just need one more. You just need two more golden bananas here. So I think. Hold on.
I think I got. So I think. So with Tiny, I have her snide.
Oh, yeah, hold on. So it scrolled through all of them again. So you have one, two.
Oh, so I have Lanky and Lanky and Tiny. So I'm good. Boom.
Do that. Nice.
Is like, where is he at? He's over here.
No, back no. The other way. And then to your right.
There.
Yeah. I don't think you have donkeys for this level. I think you just.
Yeah, why did I get donkey?
Apparently chat saw the maze fine, so I think it just like depends on what screen you're looking at it with. The screen quality, I guess.
Yeah, on my monitor I'm not like legit, it's like all black.
Interesting. I think they get more and more complicated the further we go. All these contraptions.
Yeah, no, they do, which I love.
Banana. Dad says, are you laughing at No, I was laughing at something else, Dad. Don't worry about it. Yeah, Linky.
Love this guy.
He's so great, and he's just got a chill vibe about him, too. He doesn't have a care in the world, honestly. And we should all be a little more like
that. At all.
Yeah. All right, in one stream, we did get a quarter of the golden bananas that we need to get into the last level. So I'm feeling good.
Okay. So we're doing decent.
And we got 4 of the 15 banana medals. We got 1 of the crowns. Oh, you know what? It's something we should do. We might not need to do it on stream, but that there was that battle arena that we passed earlier in the level for Lanky. It was like underwater. Do you remember what I'm talking about?
Oh, yeah, I remember. I know what you're
talking about. We don't need to do it right now, but should keep it in mind maybe before you leave this level.
Hopla. Love him. Love him so much.
I think someone pointed out that the pig has nipple piercings, I think.
Does he?
It looks like it. There's something hanging off of those nips.
Yeah, there are. There is.
What the fuck is this game, man?
I love it.
Oh, God. All right, so this one is Diddy.
Yeah, it's Diddy. Like, look how epic this is, man.
I know. It's weird that you feed the dude bananas to make him fatter so he can lift up the pig, but bananas are healthy. I mean, if you eat enough banana, if you eat enough of anything, if you need like too much.
Yeah, if you eat 100 bananas, you're gonna be fat.
Yeah. It's the 1990s. Everybody had nipple piercings. So, Dad. It's true. Here we go. This is the
dragon.
Yeah.
To be fair, I did just murder his son.
I know. And then you stomp on him even more after you murder him. It's like Diddy does have this coming. Maybe Diddy isn't cool. Maybe he's also just a war criminal.
But also, like, what do cool people do? They murder. And so,
you heard it here first from Kinda Funny Kids. How to be cool? Be a war criminal.
Murder.
No, please don't actually. No, don't.
We don't condone murder.
We don't condone murder.
Unless you're Diddy.
No.
I condone Diddy's murder.
Oh. Oh my God. Dude, this probably even inspired like Zelda and stuff. You see how like the fireballs, they get too close to the TNT barrel, it makes the TNT barrel like blow up. It's like the like the physics, you know.
Like, oh,
elemental
you're
physics.
Like,
wild type. Yeah, exactly. So this probably inspired Breath of the Wild too.
I will say I love the animation of the boss, like the way he like just throws the fire.
Yeah.
I don't know.
And also, like, when they come out of the lava and they're all pissed. Yeah.
Yeah.
I'm nervous for you. There you go.
I got hit once. I still have full health.
There we go. I think that's it.
Yeah, that's it.
Nice. Slightly Ardor says, have you guys tried Genshin? Is it Genshin Impact or Genshin? Probably Genshin.
I call it Genshin Impact.
I think it's usually a hard G.
I tried it a little bit. Like, I haven't gone back to it. I only played like an hour or so.
All right, so there we go. Before we leave this level, Blessing, let's get that second battle crown. So I think that's back in the first area.
Do I not have the other five?
No, the five is goes into that cave. where Donkey was invincible, I think. Oh my gosh. Jesus, you're so good at platformers.
Thank you, I appreciate it. You know, it's what I do.
You're like, it's just impressive, like, what you can do with the physics in games. So before you go in here, you probably should switch to Lanky. Yeah, just in case, because I don't know if there's a barrel in there to switch between all of them.
There's also a bunch of shit in this cave that we haven't done, too. Oh, man.
It's true. I think you have... If you want to do more on your own time in this level, you totally can. But I think we pretty much done like all the like minimum requirement stuff here.
Sick.
But yeah, if you want to grind out a little more before we go into the third level on the next week's stream right here on twitch.tv/kindoffunnygames, continuing Donktober with some more Donkey Kong 64. We'll start. We'll begin next stream with the Toy Factory, which I think Blessing and I can kind of both agree. That's probably our favorite level. At least thematically.
Thematically, yes.
Yeah. Got a lot of good, creepy vibes in it. And it's just so different from the first two levels that I think...
It is.
Yeah. So, yeah, I think if you go...
instrument, right?
Under... No, I don't think it's his instrument. That's a Chunky's instrument down there. If you go into the water here, and then, yeah, go through here, and then just go straight. Yeah.
Yes. There is the good stuff.
Nice. Nice.
Hold on. I don't know how, I feel like I have to be somewhat close to the metal with Linky.
I don't know.
All white.
Oh, you're so close.
There it is.
And replay the original Donkey Kong in the toy level. Oh, yeah. And we're going to have to do that twice next week.
Yeah.
You ready for that? You got to be mentally prepared for that blessing.
I'm ready for it. I think I could do a good job of that.
Okay. I believe you. Oh, so you have to hit this, and there's, like, this bird that flies around. Yeah. So that gets you a golden banana. I think once you do that, the water will go down. So, yeah, like, once you hit him once, and then he, like, shrinks. And once he gets too small, he can't, like, carry it anymore.
Gotcha. Oh, man, I do not have all the bullets right now. Shit. Okay.
Oof.
Oh, the pressure's on.
The pressure is on, Bless.
Pressure's on.
I would say wait for him.
Oh!
No, don't waste. All right, yeah, wait for him to come back over here. Nice.
Okay. Come on, where are you going, man? Where are you going? Okay, he's turning. He's coming. I can't go up.
Oh, you got this, I believe in you.
No. I don't like this. All right. God damn it.
Ah, oh, so close. I think it's only three times that you have to get him. So he's going, he has a regular pattern here.
Yeah. I just can't aim upwards enough.
Yeah.
Shit. There we go.
Nice.
So right, one more.
One more.
I have limited bullets.
No.
No, it's too late. I was too late. Why can't I go upwards more? Aim straight up, Lanky. You have the arms for it. Come on, man. All right. Which way is he turning? He's turning this way. No, he's going this way.
Yeah, he's going left.
Oh. No. All right, here we go. Oh, this is it. This is it? Yes!
Nice!
Wait, no!
I thought it was just three. It's always like three. It's always threes and fives.
They're both threes.
Yeah. God damn it.
Breathe. Oh, I can barely even see him at this
point. I know, he's so tiny at this point. He's way too tiny to be carrying that banana. Now.
Come on, drop that shit.
Oh, fuck you. So it's got to be 5 times then. God damn it. I'm so sorry, Bless.
That's all good. He's going slower.
Yeah. Which might help. So he's going to go to the opposite wall here.
I can't. Okay.
So yeah, turn around. Wait for him to come. Because you should have a good amount of time to be able to.
Turn around and wait for him to come.
No. God damn it, Bless. God damn it.
You said it, not me.
I guess.
Oh, man.
All right.
Oh, I cannot see him. All right. He's going to turn. When he turns, that's when I'm going to get him.
Okay.
Turn around and wait for him to come.
So, yeah, he's all going right. Left here. Go down a little bit. Down a little bit more.
There it is.
Nice.
We did it.
There you go.
Oh, man. That was stress-inducing.
Wait, that doesn't lower the water? What?
Maybe if I get it. There it is.
Nice. All right. So go for that battle crown here. Because then, let's see here. So yeah, after this, we've gotten 2 of the 4 crowns. We've gotten 25 of the 100 golden bananas. We've gotten 4 of the 15 banana medals. But we have yet to get either the Nintendo coin or the Rareware coin. But we'll be on our way next week.
For sure.
Barrett is like an AGDQ audience. It's true. I want Bless to succeed in any way possible, you know?
I might clean up some of the golden bananas in this level.
All right.
But I'm not going to put in Toy Factory outside the stream.
Okay, cool. Well, ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much for joining us for the very first episode of Donktober, Kinda Funny's Donkey Kong 64 playthrough with the biggest DK64 fans around. I'm Barrett. That has been Blessing Adeoye Jr., who's been playing through the game. Donktober is all about having fun hangouts, chill vibes, playing Donkey Kong 64, catching up, and making sure that we're building up to Blessing beating Donkey Kong 64 for the very first time. So thank you so much for everybody who's watching live right here on twitch.tv/kindoffunnygames, which you can do for the next 3 weeks over here as we continue Donktober at 12 p.m. Pacific time. And if you can't make it live, of course, you can watch later over youtube.com/kindoffunnygames. I think I said it on the test stream or maybe somewhere else. I think I might have said it on XCast. If everything goes well, this should in theory, this should be up tomorrow on youtube.com/kindoffunnygames. We'll see how it all goes. I don't want to promise anything, but if you miss it, fingers crossed, this should be up tomorrow over on youtube.com/kindoffunnygames. So that's the plan. Live here every Saturday, up the next day over on YouTube. Anyways, thank you so much for hanging out with us. Blessing, where can the people find you in case they don't know?
Of course, you can find me on youtube.com/kindoffunnygames, making that good content. But you can follow me on Twitter at Blessing Jr. And on Instagram and all the different social medias at the same place, at Blessing Jr.
Hell yeah. And of course, you can find me at Sad Boy Barrett on Twitter, Instagram, all that good stuff. I do my own personal streams over on twitch.tv/sadboybarrett. And Blessing, you also stream as well. You make some...
Sometimes.
Yeah.
Every now and then I'll stream.
Yeah, you play some Mario 64 every once in a while. You're making some beats, I think.
Yeah. twitch.tv/blessingjr.
Exactly.
Want to check that out.
So yeah, thank you so much. And until next time, keep on donkin'.